It is a spectacular night in the Valley of the Sun. We welcome you to the University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale, Arizona for the first ever Tostitos BCS National Championship game. The second-ranked and once-beaten University of Florida Gators go toe-to-toe with the undefeated and number one-ranked Ohio State Buckeyes. This is a huge night and a proud night for football in Ohio, not just because Ohio State is playing, but the roots for both head coaches grew in Buckeye soil. Jim Tressel in Mentor, Ohio. Urban Meyer from Ashtabula. These two men follow the long shadows of Ohio football legends like Paul Brown, like Woody Hayes, who symbolized Ohio State football for a generation, and his successor, Earl Bruce, who tutored Meyer and Tressel when both were his assistants in Columbus. Getting close to taking the field for this BCS National Championship game. And for Urban Meyer, the Ohio State graduate, he comes full circle tonight as we welcome the SEC champion, University of Florida Gators. The Florida defense, led by All-American safety Reggie Nelson, faces its toughest challenge to date here tonight. For 4 years, Gator starting quarterback Chris Leak a chance to silence his critics. Can he deliver Florida's second national title? Standing by on the field, the fourth member of our broadcast team, we welcome Chris Myers.
Tom, I'm with Urban Meyer, as you mentioned, coaching in the biggest game of his life against a school from his home state. Are you a little bit nervous?
I'm excited. I won't say nervous, excited. I'm excited for our players to let it rip a little bit and go play.
This is the team that few, if any, thought would be here. Do you feel like the underdog?
No, there's not. The people that matter are right over here in blue jerseys. We thought we had a good chance to get here if we took care of our business.
A very confident Urban Meyer. Good luck, Coach.
Thanks.
All right, and it was a week ago watching with his wife, Julie, Boise State. She said it was the greatest game she ever saw. She nudged her husband. Urban told her, wait till we play. Tom, the wait is over.
Chris, thank you. In its storied football history, Ohio State has won 7 national championships, but number 8 would be unique. No Buckeye team has ever started a season number 1 and finished a season number 1. Why will they win tonight?
We'll win it simply because everybody's playing for that guy next to him. No one's out there on the individual thing. No one's out there playing for themselves. We play for each other, and those are the reasons why.
Big Ten champion, Ohio State University Buckeyes. State is led by the nation's best player, Heisman Trophy winning quarterback Troy Smith. His favorite target and best friend since growing up together in Cleveland, the electrifying Ted Ginn Jr. We're their final ride together as teammates tonight lead to a celebration in Columbus. We again go downstairs to Chris Myers.
On the other sideline, Coach Jim Tressel, you have a chance to go wire to wire and add to the history of college football. What'd you tell your team when you ran out on the field?
Well, just to have fun. They've worked hard. They've prepared hard. They've done a great job. Now they can enjoy a great contest.
Longest layoff in championship history from game day, 51 days. How will your team handle that? How did you prepare for that?
I know they want to get it kicked off. It's time to go, and I think they handled it well.
All right, good luck, Coach. Thanks for your time. All right, Tommy, it's time to kick it off, I think.
Brent, thank you very much. And hi again, everybody. Alongside the coach, Barry Alvarez and Charles Davis, I'm Tom Brenneman, and welcome to the BCS National Championship game here on Fox. And, coach, let's start with you. Defense is your forte. Ohio State averages nearly 40 points per game. They have weapons all over the field for quarterback Troy Smith. If you're Florida, how do you slow them down?
First down's important. You want to hold them to 3 yards or less. That puts them in a passing situation. Now you match up your athletes with their athletes. You hope your athletes do match up, because I'll tell you, Tom, they will have to play great on defense tonight to have a chance to beat the Buckeyes.
And they have played great on defense the entire year. They average less than 14 points allowed per game. Mr. Davis, when the Gators have the football, some call it a matchup offense, others call it smoke and mirrors, razzle-dazzle. What do you call it?
Well, the Florida Gators call it a spread, but they come at you from enough angles to buckle your high school trigonometry teacher. They do it from a two-quarterback system to start. Chris Leak, he's the passer. Tim Tebow, he's the runner. And since they don't have a traditional good tailback to run the ball, they'll use their wide receivers in the pass game. Andre Caldwell, number 5. Jamel Cornelius, number 6. Cornelius Ingram, number 7. And Percy Harvin, number 8. They'll touch the ball in the run game and the pass game. So for Ohio State, the challenge tonight, a lot of smoke and mirrors, a lot of changes, a lot of lightning. Stay at home. Play good, sound, basic football. That'll give them a chance to win.
We go downstairs and join the officials for tonight's coin toss with our military heroes, representing Arizona, Senator John McCain, representing Florida, Colonel Bud Day, representing Ohio, Corporal Ron Rosser. Also present for our coin toss, the Fiesta Bowl chairman of the board, Mrs. Ellie Ziegler.
All right, captains, you've met yourselves now. Congratulations for obtaining this great accomplishment in football. I know you're very proud. First of all, I want to make sure you meet Senator John McCain. Captains, meet Senator John McCain. We also have, from Florida, Colonel Bud Day. Where's Bud? Colonel Day. Where's Bud? We have Colonel Bud Day there. And also representing Ohio, Corporal Ron Ressler. Okay. We're going to call the coin toss. Now, Florida, you're the designated visitors. All right? What is your call, heads or tails? Okay?
Tails.
You're gonna call tails. See, that's heads, and that's tails. So the call is tails, correct? Okay, Senator? Oh! Okay, that is tails. That is tails. Florida, we've won the call. All right. Step aside here. Florida has won the toss. They're going to defer to the second half. Ohio State?
They want the ball.
They want the ball. Which way do you want to catch?
So the Buckeyes will get the football first. Their first year of football was 1890. Florida started play in 1906. They have never played until now. It's the BCS National Championship next on Fox. Well, the parking lot jam-packed with Buckeye fans and Gator fans some 5 hours before kickoff here tonight. And now nary an empty seat in the house at this spectacular first-year venue in the suburbs of Phoenix, Arizona, in Glendale, Arizona. Coach, get back to something we talked about during the pregame show. 51 days off since Ohio State played last in beating Michigan. Florida has played twice since that time. Is that a factor tonight?
It has to be addressed. You have to address that. What Ohio State and Jim Tressel have done is sell their players. They believe in the plan that he's given them. They've gone good against good. They think they've kept up tempo, but I know in the back of his mind, he wants to set the pad, what I call set the pads. He wants to get out there and get hit and get a flow of the game and get a feel for this game.
The Florida defensive coordinators reminded us that every big game Ohio State has played in over the last 3 years, they start with something different on offense.
Yeah, it's always been a different wrinkle. You never know if they're going to come out 3 wides, 4 wides, 5 wides. Are they going to try and run the ball a little bit different? Who knows? We'll find out soon.
Joey Ehas bangs it away, and this is Ted Ginn Jr. Out across the 20, slips a couple of tackles, and Ginn down the sideline will race to the end zone. What a start for Ohio State. So much for 51 days off.
This is how you solve it. Both teams take pride in their special teams, and Ohio State, obviously, with a huge play early. Reggie Nelson right there had an angle for a moment. Ted Ginn got to the sideline and essentially outran it from behind. Great blocking from his front wall.
Aaron Petrie for the point after, and just like that, 16 seconds run off the clock. For Ted Ginn Jr., a 93-yard kickoff return for a touchdown. The first kickoff return for a touchdown by the Ohio State Buckeyes this season. And what a time to get your first.
Absolutely. You talk about speed, and all we hear about is Southeast Conference speed, but there are too many people stacked on top of each other in the middle. Too many on top of each other. The kickoff team out of their lanes.
Looked like the Heisman Trophy winner from Ohio State was pretty happy with that. Eddie George joining our Fox crew this evening.
Well, Urban Meyer prides himself on special teams. He coaches the special teams. We saw him coaching little things the other day at practice. He's got to settle his team down. It's a shocker right now. Guys, let's just settle down. Let's go back to work. Let's turn right around and let's see if we can get something back up the field. Let's get some field position.
To me, it's as simple as this. Next play, guys. You've got to let that one go. We'll correct it on the sidelines, talk to the coaches. Next play. Don't let that one affect our kickoff return.
But now dropping back for the Gators, number 25, Brandon James, a true freshman. He is a dart. Watching him in practice the other day, none of his teammates could stay with him. A line drive kick. James on one hop from his own five out across the 20. And he has daylight. And is tackled by the kicker out of the 38-yard line. And it looked like Mr. Petrie got a piece of the face mask.
That's the answer that Urban wanted.
Exactly.
That's field position right back now. Let's go to work, guys.
That's why you tell them, next play, come right back at them with the same stuff.
This is a Pac-10 officiating crew led by our referee, Jack Folliard.
Personal foul, face turn, 15-yard unit run, first down.
Right to the left of your screen. You see him grabbing right there. And dragging him down. Looks like Percy Hartman's going to open in the backfield, Tom, number 8.
The Florida quarterback, 21-year-old Charlotte, North Carolina native Chris Lee. His fourth year as a Gator starting quarterback. A 34-12 career record. That's the freshman Harbin in motion, and they get him the football immediately. And he is stopped at the 41-yard line, a gain of 5. Tackled there by the first-team All-American, James Laurinaitis. Very young up front for the Gators. What a challenge they face in this Ohio State defensive front tonight. Weapons everywhere. Deshaun Wynn, the only player on the Gator roster from Ohio.
They have opened this game without a traditional tailback. All wide receivers and a fullback.
Malcolm Jenkins shows blitz and he's coming. Leak rolling to the right. The catch is made, but short of the first down is Jamel Cornelius, the fifth-year senior from Fort Meade, Florida. The Buckeyes allowed just 10 points per game on defense this season after losing 9 of their 11 starters from last year. The only returning starters, Quinn Pitcock, a first-team All-American, and David Patterson. Laurinaitis, we talked about him. Curtis Carey starts for the injured John Kerr. And in the secondary, Antonio Smith waited 3 years after walking on at Ohio State, and he's become their leader as an all-Big Ten performer. Third down and 3.
Not a rundown ever for Florida without the with the lack of a good tailback.
Leak throws, catch is made, and it's short of the first down. That's Dallas Baker. It's very, very close depending on the spot. And that spot looked pretty generous. It might be good enough to move the chains.
He did give him a good spot.
My initial thought was that he did not have a first down from where he landed. So I agree, it's a terrific spot for the Florida Gators. Dallas Baker coming back for the football made it closer than what it probably should have been.
Chris Leak holds Florida school records for passing yards, completions, and attempts, second only to Danny Werfel with 87 touchdown passes. He's come under tremendous fire from the Gator fans, many of whom want to see Tim Tebow, and we will see Tim Tebow tonight. They hand it off to Wynn. Cuts it back to the inside. He's down to the 33-yard line and tackled by number 33, Laurinaitis. Time to take a look at our Ford keys to the game.
The illusion is Tim Tebow and the wide receivers will be the running game and get out fast. They want to get on the board first. That didn't happen because of the return. Defensive discipline for Ohio State and solid tackling after a 51-day layoff. Getting backing, as you said, Coach, setting the pads and being in proper hitting position. So key against a very quick Florida team.
Ohio State wants to make sure that defensively that they're sound in everything they do. They're seeing some things new. You really can't replicate that in practice.
Leak dumps it off to his fullback, Latsko. He has a first down to the 22-yard line. Billy Latsko, a fifth-year senior, whose grandfather, Bill Latsko, was the quarterback for the Gators back in 1940. And here comes Tim Tebow in the game for the first time. The heralded true freshman from Jacksonville. In fact, Tebow has come in, and so too in the game is Chris Leak. We saw this at practice 2 days ago.
Remember what we saw with Boise State, where they would motion a quarterback out and then have the tailback take it. Tim Tebow is a true quarterback doing that tonight.
Tebow to run it up the gut, and he's to the 14-yard line.
They use Tim Tebow is just like a running back. He is the running game, not the tailback. He is the key to their run attack.
And watch where he's going to go, straight ahead, right at him. Just lets the lineman push the defensive lineman where they want to go, and he goes straight up. Nice trap block inside by the Florida offense.
You actually outnumber the defense with that, with a fullback carrying empty backfield. You outnumber the defense out front, and you have a 235-pound tailback, in this case, running the football.
Gain of 7 for Tebow, who was the Gators' second leading rusher during the season. And Leak out of the shotgun, throws, caught by Dallas Baker. Touchdown, Gators. Saddle up, boys and girls. We had a wild one here 7 nights ago.
Some early fireworks, boys.
How about Florida on that one? Great sequence of play calling by Urban Meyer and his offensive coordinator, Dan Mullen. On the touchdown, overloaded to one side and came back to the single receiver side for the score.
You know, you can practice all you want with your scout team, but they cannot simulate the speed of the shape of the different formations and the motions that you're going to get in the game.
7 plays, 46 yards. Leak hit on 5 of 5. We are tied at 7. Just getting home from a long day's work. Welcome. This was the opening kickoff. Ted Ginn Jr. racing 93 yards. His second career kickoff return for a touchdown. He's brought back 6 punts for touchdowns. And then after the great return by James, the face mask penalty capped off with a touchdown throw from Leak to Dallas Baker, and all is even and all is right again for Urban Meyer.
And a terrific start for Florida's offense, getting Chris Leak off early. As you know, in this ball game, they want to make sure their senior leadership came to the front.
Anthony Gonzalez tackled at the 23-yard line, so only an 8-yard return that time. Good special teams coverage. Tackle made by Riley Cooper. We're back to Arizona in a minute. A 7-7 game, 10-21 still to play in the opening quarter, and now we get a look at the Heisman Trophy winner, Troy Smith. 25-2 his record as a Buckeye starting quarterback, including 10-1 against ranked teams, 3-0 against Michigan, and a winner in his only bowl start last year here in Arizona against Notre Dame. Play fake to Pittman. Smith throws, and great coverage by Tremaine McCollum. We had an eye on Ted Ginn Jr. We look at the Buckeyes up front. Big, strong, athletic. Dadish, a third-year starter, moves to center after playing tackle. Pittman, back-to-back 1,000-yard rushing seasons. The dynamic duo, they call him in Columbus, of Anthony Gonzalez and Ted Ginn Jr. Jim Tressel, 54 years old, raised in Berea, Ohio. The sixth year at Ohio State has already won a national championship. Five wide receivers for Troy Smith, and he's going to run it. And not much room. Jarvis Moss and Brandon Seiler there to make the stop. A dynamite front four for the Gators. The best Ohio State has played this year. Harvey leads him in sacks with 8. Seiler, his job tonight, to spy Troy Smith for plays just like that. And in the secondary, keep an eye on number 1, Reggie Nelson, a first-team All-American.
Let's watch as we go through the game. You have 6 defensive linemen that will continually substitute themselves. Greg Madison, the defensive line coach, allows them to go, and wants them to go as hard as they can. When they're tired, they self-substitute.
Here's where you watch for number 11. And sacked from behind is Smith by Derek Harvey. A most impressive opening stand defensively for the Florida Gators.
And the reason Derek Harvey was able to get there, actually 2 reasons. 1, his speed and skill, but 2, the secondary. The coverage back here was so good, he had nowhere to go with the ball. Did you see him clutch twice? Once, twice, thinking he's going to throw it, then Harvey gets to it. Credit the nickel secondary. 5 defensive backs clamping down on Ohio State's wide receivers early.
A.J. Trapasso, the sophomore from Pickerington, Ohio, is the Ohio State punter. The Gators figured a good field position. James comes up to get it from his own 40. And he's out to midfield. So the first Florida drive started at the Ohio State 46. This one will start at midfield, and a late flag comes in well after the whistle had been blown. This may go against Ohio State.
Tom, what I saw late was an Ohio State player take out a Florida player. Should be a personal foul.
You're right.
Florida takes the field again with a short field. The first touchdown was on a short field.
And after this call,
after the play, personal foul, late hit on the kicking team, number 6.
That's Larry Grant.
Watch to the right of the screen, coming up right there. Larry Grant.
So again, great field position for the Gators, looking for their first lead. The Gators on offense for the second time, starting a drive in Ohio State territory.
Let's see if they take a shot downtown right now.
And after a timeout, I wouldn't be surprised if they go with some type of a counter off of something they've shown already.
And Percy Harvin is taking the snap. And he's going to run it. Trying to stretch it to the outside, and he is leveled by Marcus Freeman. Boy, Percy Harvin, a true freshman out of Virginia Beach, Virginia. Only 18 years young, the MVP of the Southeastern Conference Championship game. He rushed for better than 100 yards, had 62 yards receiving and 2 touchdowns. He is something.
He's a Reggie Bush type back. They want to use him like USC used Reggie Bush. They want him all over the field. They want the ball in his hands.
A lot more like Reggie with the Saints this year, more as a receiver, but from the running back position, averaging over 11 yards per carry.
Leak back in there out of the shotgun. A little delay to Deshaun Wynn. Still on his feet. And tackled inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Let's send it downstairs to Chris Myers.
Tom, the Gators, one of those teams that script their first dozen or so offensive plays well in advance. And Urban Meyer wanted Chris Leak more involved. He visited his friend and coaching confidant, Bill Belichick, with the Patriots. Saw Tom Brady run the Thursday quarterback meeting and game plan meeting all by himself. And he said, our guy can do that. He put Chris Leak in charge. And ever since, it's worked out well. So far, for the offense anyway, the script looks pretty good.
Empty set. See if they come after him right here, Tom.
That's Wynn in motion, and Leak rolls right. Open receiver. Catch is made by Cornelius Ingram. He's inside the 10, close to the 5. A gain of 20.
You know what I'm most impressed with right now with Florida? We watch them in warm-ups. And it seems as if their offense was very jittery. The ball was on the ground a lot. They had trouble snapping the ball out of shotgun. But so far, they've been very crisp and very precise. And Chris Leak is really on his game as a thrower right now.
Boy, is he ever. He's hit on 6 of 6 for 55 yards. He's connected with 5 different receivers, but he's on the sideline. Tebow comes in first and goal at the 7.
Might show a little option pass here out of him. They're used to him running it.
Tebow inside the 5. That ball came loose. Is it loose? No signal given by the officials.
If he's down, no one made a definite call that we saw.
And still no firm indication from a member of this Pac-10 officiating crew. Apparently they're going to spot the ball at the 4, or are they?
Ruled down.
There you have it. We thank Jack Folliard, our referee.
Same play we saw him run the first time, just trapped it to the other side as he's going down. Ball being tugged out, see the knees and down, and then the ball is pulled out by number 55, Curtis Terry.
Now, we've noticed a lot of plays that he carries. There's always a discussion whether it's a fumble or not at the end of the play.
Leak back in, empty backfield, 5 wide receiver set. I don't think anybody's covering 7.
He's got to slide out a little bit. Defensive back was showing blitz. Now he slid out into a spot.
The option. Sniffing the end zone. Did he get in? Touchdown! Percy Harvin. Thanks to good returns on a kick, later a punt, 2 key personal foul penalties by Ohio State coverage teams, short fields to work with for the Gators.
But real good execution. Offensively, they're executing. Charles, you mentioned that earlier. They were not crisp in pregame warm-up, but they have been clean and putting the ball in the freshman's hand.
There may be some kind of review taking place. In fact, there is, as Jack Folliard.
Nice option. You're going to see Percy Harvin, number 8, from right to left on your screen. He's the option back. And Tom, you said he was sniffing the end zone. Does he get in or not? And that's what they're reviewing right now. Did his knee go down before he stretched across?
We'll get a better look here. He's down. Yep.
Knee about the 2 or 3 yard line.
Yep, he's down. Now the question becomes, is there conclusive video evidence? I believe they're going to take away this touchdown.
I think I agree with you, Tom, and I think they'll put the ball probably, there's the knee down right there. So I think the ball's down on probably the 1 yard line or maybe inside of it. Probably down maybe a 1 foot line because of where he was falling forward.
This is strictly a booth review. I don't think Jim Tressel is challenging the call on the field.
No, what coaches can do. And coach, you know, no flags and hankies in the college game, right? But you can ask for a review, and one time during each half. And if it's upheld, you keep your timeout. If you don't, I see 2 knees down before he falls forward. If it's not upheld, you lose the timeout.
Right. But you know what? This is what's so good about the review that I like in college football. The officials up here,
right there,
have a chance to view it. If there's question, they'll stop the game and take a look at it.
It's awfully important right here, isn't it? Only the biggest game of the year. They better get it right. See, we're up here. We have Dave Perry, the national supervisor of officials, up here with us. after the kind of talking with him, doing a little sign language.
Well,
I think we all got fooled on that one.
Fooled our booth.
I think we all got fooled.
All right. Chris Hetland, fifth-year senior, has had a rough season, hitting only 4 of 13 on field goal attempts this year. This, of course, is the extra point, and it is good. Five plays, the Gators only had to go 34 yards. Florida, ranked number 2, leads number 1 Ohio State 14-7. Notre Dame, on behalf of Singulant, would like to congratulate Brady Quinn on an outstanding senior year and thank all college football fans out there who voted. The Singular All-America Player of the Year is determined by you, the fans. And a very bright future at the next level indeed for Brady Quinn. We're back in Glendale, Arizona. The Florida Gators, with 5:51 to play in the opening quarter, lead Ohio State 14-7. Line drive kick. And again, it's Anthony Gonzalez from his own 5. Out across the 30. And Gonzalez covers that ball up and a good return out to the 35.
Florida just trying to identify where Ted Ginn is and kicking away from him.
Well, what a great week we have had here in the Grand Canyon State. The color, the pageantry, the excitement, the enthusiasm of a BCS national championship game.
Wow. This town got lively in the last 2 days, hasn't it?
About 3 bowl games for this town in the last 11 days, and the first 2 were absolutely sensational. We're off to a great start here in the 3rd one.
Ohio State out of the I formation. They'll give it to Antonio Pittman. And he's up to the 39-yard line, tackled by Ray McDonald. Ohio State on offense. Of course, they're led by the Heisman Trophy winner, Troy Smith. 30 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. His favorite target, his childhood friend. They went to church together in Cleveland. Ted Ginn Jr. and running back Antonio Pittman, the first Ohio State back since the great Eddie George, with back-to-back 1,000-yard rushing seasons. He'll share time in the backfield with the true freshman, Chris Wells. Quick throw, that is Brian Hartline, the freshman. And he is close to a first down, maybe a yard short. Going out there to get him is Derek Harvey.
I think one of the questions Ohio State wants to answer early is how sharp will Troy Smith be early in the ball game? Heisman Trophy winners notorious for having to go to a lot of banquets and dinners and all that sort. I talked with Don McPherson, who finished 2nd in the Heisman at Syracuse. He said he hardly ever practiced before his bowl game. Ohio State says that Troy Smith only missed 3 days of practice, so he really shouldn't be anything less than sharp in this ball game.
A 2 tight end set, and they give it to Pittman, and he has a Buckeye first down up to the 47-yard line. That's one thing we certainly wondered about after visiting with both teams. Would Ohio State come out and try to get physical? And look now as Ted Ginn Jr. is limping off the field on his way to the Ohio State locker room. Let's send it downstairs for more on that with Chris Myers.
Time on the Ohio State sideline. They took off his left shoe, changed padding in his left foot, and there seems to be a problem with him stepping and leaning, putting pressure. They're taking him into checkout.
Well, what a big blow that would be for Ohio State. Sacked is Smith again by Derek Harvey.
That was a 4-man pressure, and that, for Florida's defense, to be able to get that type of pressure by only rushing 4 really allows them to do a number of things in the back end.
Well, this isn't good.
That is Derek Harvey.
He leads the Gators in sacks with 8 coming into the game, 3rd most in the Southeastern Conference on the year. That is already his 2nd sack in the game tonight.
Came into the season with 1 career sack. Watch to the right of your screen. He just takes Kirk Barton, number 74, and pushes him back into Troy Smith, separates, and then runs Troy Smith down. Came into the season with 1 career sack, ended up the season with 8 sacks, has 2 tonight. Not just speed on that play, but some power, too, knocking the bigger Kirk Barton back into Troy Smith.
A great jump off the ball. First, great first step
but he got up under, him.
Low man wins, right? Isn't that what you always teach him? Low
man separated, and then he used his feet.
You know, hate to see such critical players for both teams. Ginn already has walked off the field, limped off the field, and now Harvey at least sitting up. We'll see how he's able to come off the field.
We certainly hope to have them both back quickly. But to your point, Coach, about the four-man rush, and he'll run off to the cheers of the crowd, which is great to see. To your point about the four-man rush, Charlie Strong, Greg Madison, the co-coordinators told us the best pressure they've gotten all year has been from their front. They've been able to get pressure without blitzing. So if they can continue to get that on Troy Smith and play coverage, they feel like they'll be in great shape this evening.
Stephen Harris, number 93, who plays a lot and has come on strong near the end of this season, will take over for Harvey.
Might have gotten Alex Boone, number 75, to jump. That's what Florida's going to claim.
Those tackles are sitting there, and they see the speed. They see the speed of the defensive ends, and he's trying to get a little jump on it.
Trying to set up quicker and get his first step out on a pass play.
Harvey being worked on.
So they're tightening up the shoulder pads a little bit.
This will be a second down and 25 for Ohio State. Here we are with 3:15 to play in the opening quarter and not a single yard of offense for the Buckeyes. And they've already committed three penalties. Generally, they don't commit many penalties. Florida, one of the most penalized teams in the country. Smith out of the shotgun. Great coverage downfield. Drops it off to Pittman. And he steps out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Third and long of coming. And for the Gators on defense, it all starts up front with their big four. Moss, Harvey, Cohen, and McDonald. Brandon Seiler, their force in the middle. Their second leading tackler. And then in the secondary, Ryan Smith and Reggie Nelson have a combined 14 interceptions. That's more than any secondary duo in college football. Third down and 14 for Ohio State.
It's a nickel package with three linebackers on the field, but only three down linemen rushing.
And here comes an all-out blitz. And it is intercepted at the 28-yard line. That's Reggie Lewis.
Florida showed a three-man, a three-man rush, and then blitzed off the corner. There, Ohio State is one man short. They don't have enough people to block it.
Coming from this side, right at Troy Smith, right in his face. And the hit put on him, and Ryan Smith in terrific coverage. Tremaine McCollum, number 18, the nickelback. As you said, Coach, coming from the corner position, he worked inside to the slot, came right at Troy Smith, and disrupted the play. And Reggie Lewis, now Ryan Smith, with the football.
So now the Gators start this drive at their own 29-yard line. Inside handoff to Caldwell. Looked like he thought about throwing the ball. And he's out to the 32. It'll be a gain of 4, 2nd and 6. Our dramatic overhead shots of tonight's Tostitos National Championship are provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. DLP is the official high-def TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing. It's the mirrors.
Ohio State needs a stop on defense in order to get the entire team settled right now. Because Florida's had them on the run and actually has them playing back on their heels with all their motions and shifts and the way they're utilizing these wide receivers.
Leak has been perfect on his first six throws. He's still perfect. That's Ingram across midfield to the 47. What a start for the senior Chris Leak, who has come under so much fire from the Gator faithful.
And watch the route. It's going to come Ingram from the tight end position on your left. Works into the middle. And Leak with a beautiful throw inside of Marcus Freeman, number one, and in front of Brandon Mitchell, number 32.
He's playing off his own coverage. We felt like he'd be a factor in this game. He is an unbelievable athlete.
former basketball player for the Gators.
Hey, those Hoopers can do it, can't they? They know how to do it on the campus of Gainesville.
Of course, Florida won the national championship in college basketball last year. Here's Leak under pressure this time, wide open. And all the way down to the 29 is Jamel Cornelius. And they're finding lots of holes in this Buckeye defense.
18 yards on that play. I am loving the play calling of Urban Meyer and Dan Mullen because they're showing everything right now. That was almost a little bit of a delay route, getting it into the gap. Looked like they were pushing them deep, threw it a little bit short after the receiver came out just a second late and found the dead spot in the zone.
Florida piling up the yards, and their defense thus far has silenced Ohio State on offense.
Bunch formation left, now it's more of a bunch to the right side.
Option, Leak pitches to Harvin. Inside the 25, tackled at the 23. Stop made by the redshirt freshman Donald Washington. And our aerial coverage of tonight's Tostitos National Championship game is brought to you by Budweiser Select. What a fabulous venue, this University of Phoenix Stadium in the Phoenix suburb of Glendale, Arizona, which of course next year will be home to the Super Bowl.
Looks like Deshaun Wynn, number 21, is back in the game, their true tailback. And when he's been in the game, they put the ball in his hands.
Little delay, it is Wynn trying to break it to the outside. And is shoved out of bounds by the safety, Brandon Mitchell. Loss of a yard, third and five upcoming. Well, Ohio State allows only 10 points per game. The first time this season they've allowed two touchdowns in an opening quarter. Their special teams has a lot to do with that so far tonight.
They have, and Ohio State's not used to playing from behind. And this defense has been on the field quite a few snaps.
One of our early keys. One of our early keys, Florida playing fast and getting out on top, and that's what they've done.
Third and five, they need to get to the Ohio State 19. Leak steps up, throws, and very close to a first down is Andre Caldwell, the junior from Tampa, Florida, who threw a touchdown pass in that SEC championship game, and they will move the sticks again. And how sharp is Chris Leak and this Gator offense?
Okay. Wow. Eight different players with touches already, averaging nearly 8 yards per play. The wide receivers of Florida, they call themselves the Goons. After the movie The Goonies in the 80s, everyone all together, kind of a band of brothers, they felt that they were not getting enough credit compared with the Ohio State receivers. They're obviously out to prove their point this evening.
9s are wild for Leak. 9 attempts, 9 completions, 99 yards. Went in motion, the option, and now the reverse. Coming the other way to Caldwell. All the way down, he leaps his way to the 7.
An offense like this really, at times, can put a defense back on its heels. You have so many looks, it appears as though they're having problems matching up with all the different personnel groupings coming into the game. But there's so much being thrown at them, many times you can be back on your heels and not as crisp and not as aggressive as usual.
What they've done is they've slowed Ohio State's defense down to where they're thinking instead of reacting and playing. Cloudy mind equals slow feet, and that's what's happening with Ohio State right now.
First down and goal. We're down to the final 10 seconds here in the opening quarter. And Leak to throw it, and just throws it away. Clock stops with 5 seconds left in the quarter. Leak under pressure from the sophomore Lawrence Wilson out of Akron, Ohio.
That may have been his first incompletion of the evening, but it may be his best pass of the evening because he did the right thing. Got rid of it, didn't take the sack, no loss of yardage, and here comes the hammer now at quarterback number 15, Tim Tebow.
And you ain't lying.
He is big. Hey. I couldn't get over how big he was when you see him in person.
And, you know, he lifted with the linemen when he first reported to campus. They had to back him up a little to get up to about 250.
Tebow looking for a hole. He is tackled down to the 3-yard line by Jamario O'Neal, and that will be the final play of the opening quarter. The Florida Gators ranked number 2 in front of number 1 Ohio State. We're back after a word from your local Fox station. Set to begin the second quarter at this Tostitos BCS National Championship game. The Gators third and goal at the Buckeye 2-yard line. And Leak under center.
Look at that. They're showing 3 in the backfield, full heavy set. See if they go with some type of run pass option with Leak.
They give it to Wynn. And the kid from Cincinnati gets into the end zone. A 10-play drive capped off on a 2-yard run by Deshaun Wynn. And how about this?
Tell him, Coach, you thought that they'd hammer it with Tebow. Instead, you saw Wynn, and you said to me, hey, I think he's going to pound it.
Wynn. Right now, they're doing whatever they want to do offensively.
So here we are through one quarter and one play. Ohio State has one first down. The Gators have 9, and they have 3 touchdowns.
Look at what they did with 2 fullbacks in the ball game. They used number 42, Billy Latsko, number 29, Eric Rutledge, and they led with Deshaun Wynn, pounded into the end zone.
Now you sit back and wonder about that 51 days. I know Jim Tressel and his staff did not want to use that as an excuse, and you can't let that enter your players' minds, but the fact is, we haven't seen Ohio State play like this all year.
See, the average has been 39 days in their bowl trips under Jim Tressel in terms of time off. 39, then to 51, you're adding about 2 weeks on, a little bit different territory.
I had one like in the 99 or 2000 Rose Bowl. We had nearly 41 days off, 10 days less, and we played a sluggish first half.
Maurice Wells has dropped back, a Florida kid, taking the place of Ted Ginn Jr., who brought the opening kickoff in this game back 93 yards for a touchdown. And Joey Ehas with a bouncing ball that is picked up by Roy Hall, wide receiver, and he brings it out to the 35-yard line. Time to take a look at our Dodge game summary. Well, who would have thought that? The Buckeyes only 1 first down. You're talking about a team that averages almost 40 points per game and over 400 yards of offense per game. And Leak has been lights out.
0 rush yards for Ohio State. Coming into the game, everyone thought Ohio State had a huge advantage in running the football with Antonio Pittman and Chris Wells.
Short drop, Smith under pressure again, and throws, and was the catch made? Yes, it was, on the far side by the redshirt freshman Brian Hartline, but a penalty flag is on the field. Right around the area where Troy Smith threw it, this might be a personal foul.
Yes, be roughing.
Yep. Boy, that's silly if you're a Gator.
They had gained the advantage in penalties against Ohio State. That's kicking one back to the Buckeyes.
It's important for Ohio State's offense to stay on the field here, not only because of the score, but you've got to give your defense a rest. You've got to give
15-yard penalty and snap on to the end of the play. First down.
Take a look. Number 91 and then number 40, Seiler, at the end of the play is the one who picks up the penalty. See Harvey chasing him and Seiler banging him at the end. Referee right on top of the Jack Foliard.
And after the 12-yard completion to Hartline, they march all the way down to the Florida 36-yard line. You hear it all the time about field position and penalties. And a lot of us say coach speak. How important have those two areas been tonight?
Both of these, Urban Meyer and Jim Tressel, have both been schooled in field position football. Regardless of what offense you run, it's about field position.
Empty backfield, Smith with lots of room to run. And the Heisman Trophy winner steps out of bounds inside the 25 to the 23. First down, Ohio State. A gain of 13. Let's send it downstairs to Chris Myers.
Tom, the Buckeyes moving without Ted Ginn Jr. He remains in the Ohio State locker room. They were wrapping his left ankle, checking for further damage. The trainer ran back out, grabbed some different insoles, different types of shoes to try to get him back on the field. Unofficially right now, they hope that he'll be able to return. We just don't know when.
There you get a look at his father, a legendary high school football coach at Glenville High School outside of Cleveland, who's been a great mentor not only to his son, but to quarterback Troy Smith. And that's Antonio Pittman. Carries down to the 17-yard line. Get a look at the rushing yards for Ohio State. Certainly one thing to keep in mind for many who follow the pro game. In the college game, if you're sacked, they take the yards off rushing yards. In the pro game, it comes off the passing yard.
We've seen two sacks already of Troy Smith tonight, which has hurt that average. But he will need to use his legs, as he did on a couple of plays ago, to sting him.
Antonio Pittman again, and he breaks it to the outside. Cuts it back. Touchdown, Pittman! Antonio Pittman from Akron Bucktel High School, his 14th rushing touchdown this season. And now the Buckeyes get a little momentum.
And get a chance to exhale a little bit, as everyone was getting uptight because of the way the score was going, the way the game was going. That was a very settling drive for Ohio State, aided by the early penalty against Florida.
Henry the point after, and it is good. 21-14, Florida. This is Ohio State power football.
Watch to the left side. Bang. Great blocking up front, and then Pittman bends it back and dives into the end zone.
Got great blocks from wide receivers Gonzalez and Robisky.
Now, part of history and tradition is the responsibility you have to live up to it. A burden that we welcome and we're excited about, and hopefully we will be able to add to the great tradition of the university.
Ted Ginn Jr. has made his way out of the Ohio State locker room, and his daddy wants to know, how's he doing?
Oh, coach. Coach wants him back there.
And coach better get an answer, too.
Booming kick by Petrie. And it's through the end zone, so the Gators will get it out to the 20. We have 13-27 to play until halftime. And it's been a wild start with 21-14 Florida. Our aerial coverage of tonight's Tostitos National Championship game is brought to you by Budweiser Select.
This is a very important series for the Ohio State defense. They haven't slowed Florida down yet. They have to have something or a series. They've got a little momentum. They've got to hang on to that momentum. And for confidence, they've got to be able to make a stop on this defensive series.
Their offense gave them a spark. It's up to them to continue to ignite the flame.
Still the fullback in motion. Leak again rolls to the right and just throws it away. Nobody open. Was under pressure from the sophomore out of Detroit, Michigan, Vernon Golston. A linebacker turned defensive end, and they think he has a chance to be a great one. Complete control in this game for Florida.
You look at the ball control numbers, time of possession. People get hung up on that. But look at the number of plays that they've run. So many more than Ohio State. Ohio State lost a series on the kick return by Ginn. But thus far tonight, Florida's offense has controlled things for the most part.
And it's hard to do when you don't have a running game. But Urban Meyer has done an excellent job of incorporating short passing game and everyone in the running game.
Leak across the middle, catch is made, and the see on the spot, forward progress appeared to get him to the 30 on the catch made by Jamel Cornelius. And according to our yellow line, it's good enough. It is.
Ohio State plays strictly zone defense. There are a lot of seams and open areas in zone defense. The Florida receivers are finding the soft spots. Leak likes to throw against zone defense, particularly when he has time to plant his feet and he can step into the throw. But there are a lot of seams.
And what they're doing is isolating against the linebackers, even in zone, and they love that matchup, wide receiver on linebacker.
Drake Caldwell in motion. They'll hand it off on first down to Wynn. Stiff arms, one tackle, and right behind him is Malcolm Jenkins. Holston got stiff on. He gives you an idea how strong Wynn is. Let's go downstairs to Chris Myers.
On the Buckeye bench top, Jim Haycock, the defensive coordinator of Ohio State, had huddled the defense after the last series, reminding them that no matter what formation or who takes the snap for Florida, stay with fundamentals, he said. Stay sound. One of the coaches said, don't let the frosting get in the way of the cake you're trying to eat.
Great stuff. Second down 11. They drop it off to Harvin, and he is slammed down at the 35. So a big third down upcoming for the Florida offense. And coach, you believe a big third down for the Ohio State defense. Touchdowns tonight for the Gators, thanks in large part to field position and Ohio State penalties. A touchdown throw to Dallas Baker, the option to Harvin, and the 2-yard plunge from Wynn. Third down and 5.
Keep an eye on number 7 against the linebackers. Matched up against linebackers.
Leak floats it over the middle. Catch made by Baker, and another Florida first down.
You know what's most impressive about what they're doing right now is that their wide receivers are truly fearless. They do not mind working the inside seams of the defense. And this young man, Dallas Baker, he was a guy that, frankly, Urban Meyer didn't think he was going to make it very long with him. He called him into his office and called him a clown. Said, your teammates are laughing at you. You need a better work ethic. The kid took the words to heart, and by God, he graduated already and has become one of their key performers.
Leak on first down from his own 43. And looking for the big ball. His arm got deflected, and he sails out of bounds. Vernon Bolston along with David Patterson, both right there. It looked like Patterson made contact with Leak.
That's the first pressure that Ohio State has had thus far. Any pass, that's the first time
where they really put him down. A couple times he threw it away. But Tom, you've called number 50's number a lot. It's increased in frequency in the last few plays. He's the guy that they compare to Will Smith, their great All-American on their championship team in 2002. They move him around, can do a variety of things with him, and he's really making his presence felt now.
Leak will spend a timeout. Play clock had gotten down inside of 5. 21-14 Florida. We still have 10:34 to play until halftime. So many playmakers on this Florida offense right across the board. As you talked about, Charles, 5, 6, 7, and 8 making it happen.
All playmakers, and they're joined by number 81, Dallas Baker. He just has the misfortune of having a number that's not in sequence. He doesn't get the same mention.
And he's their go-to guy.
Yes.
All season he's been a go-to guy.
Second down and 10 for Lee. Baker will be tackled for a loss of 1. Great coverage and a solid open field tackle by Malcolm Jenkins.
In the break, we talked about the lack of pressure we've seen thus far from Ohio State, but it's starting to pick up. Vernon Golston previously, there was pressure on Leak on that pass. What Ohio State wants, Jim Haycock, the defensive coordinator wants, is pressure from the front so he can play zone and not let those receivers get behind his defense.
He has stayed very patient.
Third down and 12 for the Gators. And Ohio State get a stop. Throw, good coverage, incomplete. And for the first time tonight, the Florida Gators are forced to punt. Coach Alvarez, you said that's what Ohio State needed defensively.
They needed to stop now. They're against zone coverage. Excellent play by the linebackers. Bracketed it off. Laurinaitis all over it.
And not just that, they had coverage on the backside where Chrisley wanted to throw the ball initially on the isolated one-on-one side. That took that away. He had to come back inside. Laurinaitis all over the play.
Anthony Gonzalez stands at his own 15. We'll see if Ted Ginn Jr. returns when the Buckeyes get the football on offense. Eric Wilbur, an outstanding punter for the Gators. And this one will roll through the end zone. Ohio State will get it after a 59-yard punt by Wilbur. He's one of the nation's best. Will Ted Ginn Jr. return? We'll know in a minute. Not looking real good right now for the Buckeye star.
Ted Ginn Jr., left ankle injured. That's Olympic track star Butch Reynolds, the speed coach for the Buckeyes, working with him moments ago. His eyes watering. Ginn Sr. was told by the trainer they hope to get him in the game at some point. But right now, Ted Ginn Jr. not able to play and upset, stomping his feet on the bench, saying, I want to go in there. But the coach's decision now is to hold him off because of that ankle, Tom.
Great stuff, Chris. We thank you. And Troy Smith out of the I formation to throw on first down. Unbelievable protection. And it looked like he had to just get rid of it, throws it away. Had an eye on Anthony Gonzalez. Boy, a rare breed in the college football world indeed is Anthony Gonzalez. Not only a sensational player, clutch receiver, but a 4.0 academic student who majors in philosophy and has said long after his football days are over, he plans on attending Stanford Law School. What an impressive young man he is.
The Florida coaches will tell you the best route runner as a football player. Student of the game.
Now the shotgun, Smith rolling right. Finds Robiski, who's shoved to the ground, and that's an incomplete pass. Robiski dropped it.
I'm a little surprised by this series. Ohio State had success handing the ball off, moving the ball. Really, Florida hasn't stopped them in their I formation run game, and they went away from it. I thought they'd come right back to it.
Look at the coverage by number 30, Earl Everett, right in the zone with Brian Robiski, and the big hit jars the ball loose. Now it's third and long for the Buckeyes.
Ohio State 1 of 3 on third downs thus far tonight. A 5 receiver set for the Buckeyes.
He may have to dart up through there if he gets pressure.
The ball appeared to be tipped at the line of scrimmage, and it sails incomplete. So after an Ohio State defensive stop, Florida forces a 3-and-out.
Watch coming from the right side, number 94, Jarvis Moss, the hero of the South Carolina game, with 2 block kicks. It helped Florida win the game, put the pressure on Troy Smith.
Ohio State showed blitz and bailed out of it. Got an offensive line, the blocking scheme went away from it, and turned Moss loose.
Yeah, everyone moving to the right side, opened up the left side for number 94, Jarvis Moss, and he took full advantage of it.
Repasso, a low line drive kick, fielded by James, who spins away from one tackle, and then is wrapped up. A great field position again for Florida. Starting this drive from their own 42, 44-yard punt, 7-yard return by James. .904 to play until halftime. 4-year starter Chris Leak in the Florida Gators. A 7-point lead over number 1 Ohio State. It off the rim, slips it to the outside, still on his feet. A 5-yard carry. We brought up earlier Deshaun Wynn, an outstanding running back in the Cincinnati area at Reading High School. Jim Tressel came down to watch him twice in person. the 10 best players in the state of Ohio that year, Tressel got all of them except for Deshaun Wynn.
That's because Maurice Claret signed that year. And Deshaun Wynn wanted to be somewhere else. Looks like we might have, do we have two quarterbacks on the field
yes.
now?
Yep. Leak under center and Tebow in the backfield. And now Leak will split left and Tebow will run it. Picks up a couple. Tripped up by Quinn Pitcock. A gain of four, it brings up third and two.
It's interesting you brought up that recruiting class. Who was the last guy they signed? The last guy they took that year?
Troy Smith.
Troy Smith was the last one they took. Claret the first.
So much for recruiting rankings and services at times, right?
Urban Meyer, in fact, recruited Troy Smith to play at Bowling Green when he was a head coach there before leaving to Utah. 2 years there. And now his second year at Florida.
Just three down linemen in again. They've done that the whole series, has Ohio State.
Leak rolls. Still looking. Throws, catch is good for a first down to his tight end, Cornelius Ingram, to the Ohio State 45.
How about that young man? Coming into this game, his last four ball games, he had 16 catches. Entering the South Carolina game, which was late in the year for them, yeah, he'd only had one catch on the season.
Yep.
So he has really, truly emerged, and he's a guy who's really bought in to the Urban Meyer way because he quit last year.
1 year ago.
He was done.
1 year ago.
He was finished.
Quit.
Some guys talked him out of it, and now he's coming along, and they think he's going to be really special.
They told us he'd be in the game plan today. Showing blitz.
Harbin inside the 40, down to the 37-yard line, and his play calling clearly keeping the Buckeye defense off balance.
You know what's also happening is we talk about missing tackles in the open field. I haven't seen that much of that with Ohio State, but what I have seen as we look at the numbers there in rushing yards and passing yards, what I have seen is that there's enough space when they catch the ball that they still have an opportunity to make one quick move and still get up the field and gain additional
that's
yardage.
That's about a 4-3 athlete in space with Laurinaitis, a linebacker.
No one's close enough to immediately put him down.
Harbin this time in motion, and they're going to get the ball in his hands once again. And plenty of daylight for Percy Harbin. And the freshman from Virginia beats Virginia. Brings it down to the 20-yard line.
We've talked about the three-man rush, but Ohio State's also playing with three linebackers. Watch to the right. Watch the blocks downfield. There and there and up here by the receivers. That's going to clear some space for Percy Harbin to get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Charles, look, 5, 6, and 7.
Did we talk about those numbers?
But look at how they blocked. They're not just catching the ball. They're out there covering up defenders.
And they're not big guys, but they will stick their heads right into the numbers of the defenders.
Caldwell, they fake the handoff to him. And a dangerous throw by Lee. He had an eye on his fullback Latsko, but almost there to get it was Vernon Golston. Coach, let me ask you, if you're Ohio State, it's hard to find a lot of good so far in this first half, but you're only down 7. What are you thinking right now if you're that man?
I know right now. Jim Haycock is a conservative call play caller, but he will heat it up and play press, play man-to-man and blitz you from the 20-yard line in. But he's been very conservative.
Incompleted pass. Again, they had an eye on Harbin, and right there was Malcolm Jennings. So a 3rd and 10 upcoming for the Gators at the Ohio State 21.
Coach, that looked like a zone blitz because Vernon Golston, number 50, who's their guy that they use to move around and try and create mismatches, lined up down with his hand down and then dropped back into the middle into coverage. He wasn't a factor because the pass went to the outside, but it was a different look for Ohio State.
You could see something of that nature again, just to make the ball come out a little quicker. Change the timing. Don't allow Leak to sit there and have a good look at your secondary.
Harbin in motion, and that's a penalty. Early movement along the Gator offensive line.
Ball start on the offense, number 7. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So now you go from third and 10 to third and 15, and let's not forget the field goal kicker for the Gators.
Exactly what I was thinking, Tom.
Chris Hedlund in what is shaping up to be a wild game here tonight, and we'll see if it plays out that way. But field goal kicking so critically important, and it has been a horrific year for Chris Hedlund.
And it's incumbent upon the Ohio State defense to put Florida in that situation and make them attempt a field goal at this time.
They need to get to the 11 for a first down. Luke steps up with an eye on the end zone and just throws it away.
Good coverage. Good zone coverage. Everyone covered up.
But I would have liked to have seen Chris Leak dart on that play. He had a gap, moved to his left. I would have liked to have seen him try and take it upfield and at least gain some additional yardage for your field goal kicker.
Now, Chris Hedlund this season, we mentioned, has made 4 of 13. Last year, he was a second team All-SEC performer when he hit on 13 out of 16. This is a 43-yard attempt, his long this year, 33. And he hammers it right down the middle. Hello, Chris Hedlund.
Was that big for his confidence? Huge for his confidence.
He had been 1 for 10 outside of 30 yards this year prior to that kick. That's huge for Urban Meyer because it changes your mindset on offense.
Well, you got to feel good for that kid, Hedlund. It's been a tough year. He's given him a 10-point lead. Our dramatic overhead shots of tonight's Tostitos National Championship game provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. DLP is the official HD TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing. It's Samir's. What a fabulous shot that is to watch football. Wow.
Can I get one of those at the house? Any possibility of that?
The way you've been working things this week, it's probably a real good chance.
I would not operate that bad boy, though, would I?
Hammered out of the end zone by Ehas. And celebration on that Florida sideline, and why not? Everybody rooting for Chris Hedlund.
Especially the head coach, don't you think? Because now he doesn't have to always think about 4-down territory because he has an erratic kicker. He's got some confidence now in his kicker, and his kicker has confidence in himself.
There was as much a sigh of relief from that sideline as there was from Hedlund.
Didn't they make waiting to exhale in the state of Arizona? That's exactly what happened there for the Florida bench.
Well, Troy Smith, who's had an extremely quiet first half, starts this drive with under 6 minutes to go. His team down by 10. They hand it off to the true freshman, Chris Wells, and he picks up 2.
You know what my surprise has been early in this game, guys? Is that Ohio State has not gone with their 4-receiver look and run the ball inside very often. That's how they've been very successful most of the year. Spread people out, create your running lanes up front, and hand it off inside. I haven't seen much of that.
But most of the year, Charles, they played with Ted Ginn Jr. How does that change things for Ohio State?
Well, it changes it because now who's your push guy downfield to create the open lanes? Anthony Gonzalez could be that guy. Remember, he's a 4-3 guy, but he's learned to be more of a possession guy because Ted Ginn's provided the speed.
Second down and 8, they run the option and the pitch to Wells, and he's close to a first down, appears to be a yard short. Tackle made by Brandon Seiler.
Jim Tressel told me during their practices after the season, he thought Chris Wells improved greatly. Just understanding things a little better, having a little time away as a true freshman. When he came back, he said he was a different player.
Sometimes getting away from it clears your head and gives you a better look at things as we look at Florida with 209 total yards already in the first half.
I'm not sure Smith got it.
No movement.
No push up front at all. Florida won that battle across the front. And in a big way.
Yeah, they're short. Ohio State on 3rd and a yard, cannot convert.
I think Jim's thinking about it.
He's thinking about it, but I don't think he's going to do it. That's not really his nature. I'm surprised.
He's going for it.
Does he really think he needs to jumpstart the team that much? I guess so. Maybe he might try to draw him off, guys.
They're going to run a play. And did he get enough? That extra lunge by Wells wasn't enough. If not, Florida's going to get the ball back. They are denied by the Gator defense. Joe Cohen is down, injured on the field for the Gators.
Look inside. Watch the defensive lineman. They push the offensive line back into the play. Number 93, Stephen Cohen.
Ray McDonald. Ray McDonald with penetration.
Stephen Harris. Look at that. Stephen Harris, 93, pushing them back into the play. And then the linebackers clean up. What a terrific job at dealing. Coach, you talked about him before as we see Joe Cohen down and getting some attention. But you talked about him all during our preparation, how impressed you were with the defensive front of Florida.
Well, Greg Madison has done a tremendous job with this group. He rotates six. He has the philosophy, we're going to play 100 miles an hour. When you're tired, we'll get someone else in there. When you're fresh, we'll put you back in. But Maddie has them playing hard. You see these guys were coming off the ball. They set the tempo for the game initially with their pass rush. Now, two big plays in a row in short yardage runs.
And certainly many will ask Coach Trussell about this decision to go on fourth down at your own 29-yard line with 3.5 minutes to play until halftime, and the Gators already with a 10-point lead.
Look how they just take the front wall and push them back and over the top. McDonald first before Seiler and the other guys get involved. Joiner number 19. To me, I get the sense that it's a little bit of desperation from Jim Tressel. He's trying to wake his team up. And he went for it there, and that one really did not pay off. Look at that penetration by all the blue shirts. They're in the backfield of Ohio State. I attack right here if it's me and Urban Meyer. If I'm Urban Meyer, I'm attacking right now.
Leak out of the shotgun. Clock starts. Fakes the throw. And then just slides down to the 29-yard line. This Gator defense, we wondered, would they be up to the challenge against Ohio State? And the answer so far, a definitive yes.
They've been great all year. They're one of the top defenses in the country. I felt, look at the hits.
Tony Joyner there, McCollum forcing the interception for Reggie Smith, excuse me, Reggie Lewis. Then McDonald there with the play with a lot of help from his friends. What I've been most impressed about Florida's defense is how physical they've been. Everybody talks about their speed. Greg Madison says, we're physical too.
Harbin will take the snap from center out of the shotgun. Fakes one way, cuts it back the other. And he's down to the 23-yard line. It'll bring up third down and 3 for the Gators. Clock rolling close to 2:30 to play until halftime. Well, you can't feel any better than the Gators feel so far tonight on defense. Look at some of these numbers. Astounding.
69 total yards given up already against one of the most high-powered offenses in the country.
Deshaun Wynn all the way to the top of your screen. Empty backfield on 3rd and 4. Play clock nearly expired, and Luke has to call a timeout, stopping the game clock at 2:03. Well, the Gators with a 10-point lead, trying to tack on to it before halftime. Back in 1999, the Volunteers won the first BCS championship. Florida State in 2000, Bob Stoops and the Sooners a year later. The Hurricanes under Larry Coker in 02. The Buckeyes beat the Hurricanes under Jim Tressel. Nick Saban and the LSU Tigers won it in 04. Pete Carroll and the Trojans in 05. And of course, last year, the great finish directed by Vince Young for the Texas Longhorns. Who will win the BCS National Championship this year? So far, it's all Gators.
Ohio State defense right now, it's a big stop. If they could come out of this after not making that fourth down call, come out of here with a field goal.
A field goal would be huge. And for Florida, it'd be a huge disappointment after that big defensive stand and not converting that into 6 points. It's all up to the Ohio State defense now.
Harbin in motion. Leak pump fake. And the throw is too tall for Dallas Baker. So fourth down. Does Urban Meyer change his thinking and go here on fourth down? We call it fourth and four.
I go ahead and kick the ball. The kid has already made one. He's got his confidence up. Now's the time to go ahead and give him a shot. You're already up 10.
If he would have missed that last field goal,
he's going for
it. He's probably going for it.
No problem. He's going for it. He's going to give him one chance early, and if he didn't like what he saw, he was changing his thinking.
Petlin, a season best 42-yarder a moment ago. This one from 40 on the nose. Good snap, good hold, and a great kick again by Hetland. How about that? So Hetland has half the number of field goals in his BCS National Championship game tonight through two quarters, a little better than 2 minutes, than he had all year long.
You know, Urban said it's not like he's shanking the ball. He's hitting the ball well. It's just not going through.
Yeah, he said he was just missing by, you know, just missing just by a little bit. He said it's like a golfer. If you're stinging the ball, that's one thing. As you know, I can live with that because I know we can work that out. But if you're shanking it and hooking it and doing all that, that wasn't so good. But Chris Hetland has been stinging the ball. Thus, he kept giving him opportunities. And tonight, 2 for 2 and giving his team a real lift.
Ohio State has all three timeouts remaining. A minute 53 on the clock. And the Buckeyes are still without their number one threat on offense, Ted Ginn Jr.
You know, if you go back before this game started as the kickoff begins, I'll try and finish it after this kickoff.
Maurice Wells will take a knee. And Ohio State will start this drive from the 20.
You know, as I was saying, guys, before this game started, how much did we hear about strength versus speed, and was that a myth, and was that real, was that right? Big Ten strength, SEC speed. Well, both teams wanted to prove the opposite. Ohio State wanted to tell the world, hey, we can run with anyone. Ted Ginn Jr.'s injury has hurt that a little bit. Florida wanted to tell everyone, we're as physical as anyone. Tonight, Florida's been more physical than Ohio State to this point.
Third straight Ohio State possession to start from their own 20. They're going to come out throwing. Now Smith is caught from behind. The ball is loose. Harvey has it. Florida ball at the 5. Jarvis Moss stripped it, and Derek Harvey picked it up.
Have these defensive ends been blocked yet? Look over here and over here. Here they come. Have they been blocked really well all night? I would say not really. Look at that. Jarvis Moss strips it. Derek Harvey picks it up. Florida is in business. And do you come with the hammer right now, Coach? Do you bring Tebow in and pound right at him? I say yes.
He's in.
I'm coming with the big guy and running right at him right now while they're a little unsettled.
Florida still has one timeout left.
Clock under a minute 15. Tebow will run it up the gut. And he's down to the 2-yard line. The clock continues to run. As Coach mentioned, one timeout remaining.
Plenty of time, though, in the position they're in. They don't have to go crazy in terms of their hurry up. They want to move it, but they still have time. We think, Coach, right back at them.
Do it again, and then you've got your timeout to burn to get a good look on third down.
What a night Derek Harvey's having, huh?
What a night the Gators are having. Trying to add to this 13-point lead. And no. Down to the 1. That'll bring a 3rd and goal for the Gators. Clock under 30. 1 timeout left, and they will spend it now.
As I watch Tim Tebow, I'm reminded of what a couple of SEC head coaches told me prior to this game. Without Deshaun Wynn in the ballgame, and you know, when he's been dinged so much this year, Tim Tebow is their only north-south runner.
Our spectacular aerial coverage of tonight's Tostitos National Championship game is brought to you by Budweiser Select. And what an opening half it has been for the Florida Gators. Once beaten by Auburn in a Southeastern Conference, went on to defeat Arkansas in the SEC championship game. Ohio State undefeated. Key victories this year at Texas and the season finale over Michigan. But Troy Smith and the Buckeyes are down by 13, and they're hoping that's where it will stay when we reach the intermission.
It appeared that Ohio State had weathered this storm to a good extent by only giving up a field goal. Then they turned right back around, and now it can be an extra touchdown tacked on after Jim Trestle's decision to go for it on fourth down deep in his own territory.
Critical stop again. If they can stop them right here, you're probably going to get a field goal unless they call two times. They may have called two plays in the huddle.
Coach, he has run pass option available to him with Tebow.
Tebow.
There it is.
Touchdown throw to Andre Coleman. State allowed 10 points per game this season. After the point after attempt by Hedlund, the Gators are about to fire up a 34 spot on the Buckeyes. And that's what it is. Now, honestly, anybody watching out there, even the most hardcore Gator fans, did you see this coming?
Not to this extent. The consensus and the run-pass option pays off with a touchdown to Caldwell. Able to get outside. He really had a couple of targets. Had Cornelius, number 6, in the back of the end zone. Also available. Why was it so open? Because of the running ability of Tim Tebow. All he's done is run the ball straight ahead tonight. This time, two jab steps forward and then flattens out and throws it out. Throws it out to the wing for a touchdown. Malcolm Jenkins, number 2. Jamario O'Neal talking about what the coverage was supposed to have been. No one had the receiver on that play.
It's been confusion all night for the Buckeyes on defense. Florida has scored on 6 of its 7 possessions. Now you're talking about a Gator team that averages 28 points a game. They have 6 more than that right now.
Tom, as you mentioned, the consensus coming in was that if this game came down to Florida would win a tight one, Ohio State would win one with this type of a score. Many people question whether Florida could score enough points to win this game based on the offense we've seen all year.
This is Hall to bring it back across the 29 to the 30. Coming up on the blockbuster Total Access halftime, it'll be Chris Rose, Emmett Smith, and Eddie George with all the first half highlights. We'll hear from both bands, plus a special presentation from Habitat for Humanity.
You know what's interesting to me right now? Is that Jim Trestle went for it on fourth and short in his own territory. Here, he might just take a knee and just get the heck out of here and end the half. Real juxtaposition, going from gambling to being conservative if he does that.
Yep, they're just gonna hand it off to Antonio Pittman. He'll pick up 10, and that will be the final play in what has been, wait a minute, we have a flag on the field. And the officials telling everybody not so fast.
Reggie Lewis, the Florida defensive back, indicating that the penalty should go against Ohio State, but that's normal, isn't it? Everyone points the finger at the other guy.
It's never me.
Personal foul on the defense, number 22. Penalty is 15 yards from the end of the run. First down.
See, and he was locked up with Brian Rabisky blocking on the perimeter. Reggie Lewis was telling his coaches, kind of like, he got me first. Well, that doesn't matter much. They caught him for the penalty.
And Ohio State's going to call a timeout. The ball is being placed at the Florida 45. Do you just throw a Hail Mary here?
Now you take a shot. That 15 yards allows you to get one, just throw it down the field, a Hail Mary, possible interference.
And this is why guys such as yourself, Coach, go bonkers when those types of penalties occur.
Foolish
half should have been over. Should have been in the locker room right now. Now they get another shot. You throw it up, you get a defensive penalty, the play stays alive, or they get a tip and they get some momentum going in.
Well, you give them a chance when you should be in the locker room.
Look at that. 61 total yards, fewest in the first half this year for Ohio State.
It's interesting to note that that is the fourth personal foul penalty we have had in this game. The other three have directly led to touchdowns so far tonight.
Is that a precursor, Tom?
We'll find out. And, of course, the gang is standing by. Chris, Eddie, Emmett, and the coach, Jimmy Johnson.
The only one sitting on that set that will say that he saw it coming will be Emmett Smith.
How about this defense, Florida?
Just spectacular. And I just think they've been so physical in the first half. They've really proved the point in the first 30 minutes thus far.
Florida with five defenders inside the 10-yard line. Smith going to step up and let it fly to the corner of the end zone. Incomplete. And what a first half for the number two Florida Gators. Their only national championship was under Steve Spurrier in 1996. And with 30 minutes to go in this one, they have a 20-point lead. Let's go downstairs to Chris Meyer.
Urban Meyer on his way to the locker room. Wow, what do you think?
We got 30 minutes of football left against a great football team with a lot of speed, so we're going to have to keep that ball in front of us the second half.
I know, Urban, you script offensive plays. Could you have scripted any better your defense?
Our defense played well all year, and it's a lot of football left, so we got to remember who we're playing here.
Have you confused the Buckeye defense with your offense?
No, I don't think so. I think we just have some good playmakers making some plays, and I think we have some very fine athletes that are making some plays on the perimeter right now.
All right, enjoy the second half. Thanks, Coach. All right, they get the ball first time of the second half.
Urban Meyer, born in Ohio, grew up in Ohio, played at Cincinnati, got his degree, master's degree from Ohio State. His Florida Gators lead his once-beloved Buckeyes 34-14 at halftime.
Welcome to the Blockbuster Total Access Halftime Show on Fox.
Florida has scored on six of its first seven possessions and is shocking the world, leading number one Ohio State 34-14. Hi, everybody, and welcome to the Blockbuster Total Access Halftime Show here on Fox. I'm Chris Rose, once again joined by Emmett Smith, Eddie George, Jimmy Johnson. And Emmett, have you noticed that Eddie George very quiet throughout that first half?
Yeah, Eddie has been very quiet. He has a reason, too, because Ohio State has struggled this whole first half.
There is a second half, but it's not looking too good for the Ohio State Buckeyes right now.
Well, one reason it's not looking good, what was Jim Tressel doing there toward the end of the second quarter, going for it on fourth down at his own 29, Jimmy?
Yeah, this Ohio State team's in shock right now. They had only one meaningful game last year. That was against Michigan, and they have given up 73 points the last six quarters. Going for it on fourth down, your own 29, that's panic to me. Yeah.
It reminds me of a play that we ran up in Philadelphia.
Not with me coaching
right,
you.
Not with me coaching.
Hey, guys, you know what? The first half has been more like a track meet than a football game. It started about a half hour before kickoff. Both teams having a meeting of the mind at midfield. It didn't get quite ugly until kickoff. Then Titgen Jr. took over. 93 yards. It's his eighth return for a touchdown. But Ginn, what'd you say?
Holding.
Oh, what?
They missed the holding call.
You're winning by 20, and you're still complaining. Ginn played very little in the first half because of a bum ankle, but Chris Leak definitely. Oh, look at Eddie George all bumped up. That's about all he had to be excited about. Here, Leak, beautiful touch pass to Dallas Baker. They come back and score on their first drive and tie it at 7. Then they get creative. They were doing it all first half. Percy Harvin, the freshman, mixing it up and giving the Gators the 7-point lead. Then, Deshaun Wynn, the team's leading rusher, plowing in from 2 yards out. It's 21-7 Florida. Ohio State did come back. Little used Antonio Pittman in the first half, breaking it off for 18 yards, and the Buckeyes are back within 7. But Troy Smith, just 2 of 8 for 24 yards in the first half. He's been sacked 3 times. Here he gets stripped by Jarvis Moss, one of 2 Buckeyes turnovers. Gators are then going to take it in from there. It's the freshman Tim Tebow not running it, but passing it to Andre Caldwell. They lead it 34-14 at the break. And Chris Leak, one huge reason why, Jimmy, because he is keeping the chains moving.
Yeah, Ohio State came into this game wanting to pressure Chris Leak. The only thing, Urban Meyer did a great job. He put him in the shotgun. He threw the underneath patterns. And with the four-man rush, they couldn't get to Leak. He got rid of the ball too quickly. Now, they converted on third down conversions. And the first time that Ohio State was able to stop him was when they went to the three-man rush late in the second quarter.
What else Chris Leak has shown, Coach, has been the ability to show poise. He's been very poised throughout this whole first half. He's showing the poise that we normally would see from Troy Smith. Troy Smith is the guy that looks like he's panicking right now and maybe feeling a little bit of the Heisman pressure.
But I know about the Heisman pressure, but it's probably the pressure from their front four being in Florida. They produced three sacks. They've caused him to move his feet in the pocket, feeling unsettled. And it looks as if Troy is a step behind. It looks like he's that layoff is having his effect on him. And I believe that right now, Florida has the momentum. They have the emotion. Being on the Ohio State sideline, I don't see any signs of life.
All right, guys.
Florida has all of it right
put
now.
Put your coaching cap on right now for the second half of your Jim Tressel, what do, Jimmy?
And we talked about it in the pregame show. If you're down, you're not out. There's a lot of talent on this Ohio State team. They can come back. But you've got to stop turning the ball over. You've got to get back to running the football and running your offense. You've got to quit taking all the panic chances and going on fourth down. So they can come back, but they've got to get back the way they know how to play.
Well, yeah. when I look at the keys for the second half, first of all, Jim Tressel got to figure out a way to bring his team back and rally his troops, because going for it on fourth and one did not help. So I'm interested to see what kind of speech he gave these guys at halftime. Secondly, Gators got to continue to do what they've done in the first half. Stop the run, continue to get turnovers, and do a better job at special team play.
Well, they've done an outstanding job in every area, in every facet of the game. When I look at Ohio State, for them to come back, they're going to have to settle down, establish the running game. Don't worry about the score at this point in time. It's irrelevant. What happened in the first half, happened in the first half. You got to continue to move on. Troy Smith has to settle down, make his plays, make it one play at a time. I know it's a cliche, but really, it's one play at a time.
Eddie, you might have to get used to that Gator chomp. You
hey,
might be
man,
doing
it
come post-game.
They're doing a great job. They're doing a great job.
I like that.
They're doing a great job.
You've been working on that?
Great
That's
job.
Nice. Hey, only twice during their 19-game winning streak has Ohio State actually trailed at the break. Right now, Florida leading number one Ohio State 34-14. Who's going to get their hands on the BCS Coaches Trophy presented by Turek TV? We're going to find out. And if you want to download any of the BCS Bowl Bash games, including the Game of the Century, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, log on to foxsports.com on MSN. Keyword, Bowl Bash.
We now listen in on the Pride of the Sunshine, the Florida Marching Band, under the direction of John Watkins. Listen and enjoy. State Marching Band, the pride of the Buckeyes, the best damn band in the land, and their band director, Dr. John Woods. Over the last week, Tostitos and Habitat for Humanity united rival fans from Ohio State and Florida to make one family's dream of owning a home come true. Let's take a look now at this wonderful story.
Sometimes when you least expect it, life throws you a wonderful pass.
A week ago, single dad Fred Banks and his daughter Natalia believed they were throwing a pass for $100,000 for Habitat for Humanity.
Tostitos and the Habitat team of volunteers are working on a new home for you and your family on the Jumbotron. Next week, Tostitos, when you're watching the BCS National Championship game, your family will have a new home that will be completed at that time.
To build a house in 1 week instead of 13 weeks really takes a great crew of people like we have today.
The way we did that was by using rival volunteers from both Ohio State and Florida to work for somebody that they didn't even know.
What we're seeing today usually takes us 2 months to get to this point almost.
In 4 days, we're playing Florida for the national championship. But right now, we're working on this house as teammates.
Fred Banks didn't have to qualify for his home, and he also contributed 400 hours of sweat equity on other Habitat builds.
Now we're seeing everything take shape.
Right now, I've got goosebumps.
I think everybody's here today, they just want to do something good for a good family.
The wonderful thing about this house is you've got the competing fans from Florida and Ohio State coming together to do such a wonderful thing for Fred and his daughter, Natalia.
I am thrilled to present you with your new key for your new home. Make good things always happen.
I really wanted my daughter Natalia to have a safe place to grow up. It's just a great feeling to know that my daughter will have some place to call home.
Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate Fred Banks as he raises the ceremonial key to his new house with volunteers from Ohio State and Florida. Fred, congratulations to you and your family. ...34-14 Florida in front, back to the University of Phoenix Stadium in a moment. We're set to announce the winner of a $100,000 general scholarship fund contribution from Pontiac. Let's go to the campuses of our four finalists: Oregon State, Auburn, the University of Iowa, and Clemson University in South Carolina. Nearly 1 million votes for Cast, and the winner, Auburn University. And here's the play that won it for the Tigers.
He'll take the snap, and he drops it. And he's going to try and pick it. He can't do it. Auburn picks up the ball. Face mask. Touchdown, Auburn. Touchdown, Auburn. Touchdown, Auburn.
Congratulations, Auburn. That game-changing performance just earned your school a $100,000 general scholarship fund contribution from Pontiac. And we'll be back with the start of the second half after this. We're set to begin the second half at the University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. 34-14, number 2 Florida leads number 1 Ohio State. The Gators scored on 6 of their 7 first half possessions and will get the football to begin the second half of play. James steps out of the back of the end zone, and the Gators will get it at the 20. The 48 points scored in the first half tonight tied for the most in a BCS national championship game. USC and Oklahoma scored 48 back in the 2005 FedEx Orange Bowl. The numbers clearly in Florida's favor.
Look at the turnovers. 2 turnovers, 14 points off those turnovers for Florida.
That's our Tostitos first half statistics.
71 total yards in the first half for Ohio State's offense. But right now their defense has to set a tone to help bring their team back into the game.
The defense can't just sit in zone coverage. They're going to have to take some chances this half.
And Malik out of the shotgun, fumbles a snap, recovers in time to throw it away. Wisely done by the 4-year starter and quarterback Chris Leak. Let's send it downstairs and check in with Chris Myers.
Tom, Jim Tressel said that he can't count on Ted Ginn Jr. in the second half. Right now, his ankle is being x-rayed, so the Buckeyes are not counting on him. Tressel said the fourth down gamble, he said that wasn't so bad because our defense did a good job of holding him, but I had to show some confidence in this team. Tressel said we can come back, even though we haven't faced this kind of deficit before. He was confident and cordial.
Chris Myers, thank you very much. Second and 10 for the Gators. And that'll be a penalty against Chris Leak, I believe.
False start. Number 21 on the offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
They got Deshaun Winn.
Kind of had their choice, didn't they?
You know, it was interesting. As we
look at these numbers. Coach. Who would have thought Troy Smith, 2 of 8, yep. An interception on 24 yards in the first half. Chris Leak outplaying the Heisman Trophy winner thus far.
Well, they haven't been able to run their offense. They've completed a couple passes. They really haven't established a running game. They haven't been able to get into any groove. But we'll find out what they're made of. There's a lot of football left to be played.
A lot left.
With a delay to Win, who spins his way close to the 20. It'll bring up third down and 11 for the Florida Gators on this opening possession of the second half.
You know, it was interesting. As we watched pregame, we saw the snap to the quarterback on the ground 4 or 5 times. As we watched films throughout the season, we saw the same thing. Yet Florida came out and played flawless. Now, here you go. You saw it on the ground. Let's see if they can keep their intensity.
The defensive line for Ohio State has to get to Leak. We have not called Quinn Pitcock's name much tonight. The All-American defensive tackle.
Leak steps up under heavy pressure, gets the pass completed, and an open field stop made by Marcus Freeman on Jamel Cornelius, so it's 3 and done for the Gators to begin the second half offensively.
And that was a huge tackle for a variety of reasons. Number one, it's a terrific play by Marcus Freeman, just how you draw it up. But number two, open field in space, one of the few times the Florida Gators have not made the first guy miss.
One of the few, that's the first time we've seen him drop him right there,
right on the spot.
No extra yardage.
A lot of movement in this punt formation for Florida. Angling toward the sideline, a punt by Wilbur, and a terrible kick. You gotta wonder why you're getting cute. You have a 20-point lead, and you're asking your punter to do something which is completely unnatural.
It was a rugby kick, and he's been kicking well.
A 20-yard punt by one of the nation's best punters.
What happened here, I think, is that Coach Meyer was trying to get a little something extra that maybe they just didn't need. Eric Wilbur's been a terrific punter from regular formation. And this first and second half has started out exactly as Ohio State needed. A stop on defense, great field position to start on offense.
In the I formation, Stan White Jr. In front of Antonio Pittman, they give it to Pittman on first down. And he is dropped behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of 4 by Brian Crum and Brandon Seiler. 7 possessions in the opening half for an offense that averages nearly 40 points per game and over 400 yards of offense, and not much there.
Look at that, guys. 64 yards, the longest drive they had, resulted in a touchdown, but you're looking at -3, -6, 9 yards, 0. This very uncharacteristic of Ohio State offense.
This all starts with that defensive front.
And we already saw it the first play, the push the defensive line is getting on the offensive line of Ohio State.
And they're showing blitz on second down and long.
Screen.
They fake the screen. Smith steps out of trouble and will keep it himself, crossing midfield to the 47-yard line. It'll bring up third down and 11 for the Buckeyes.
Florida's showing blitz and creating some problems with pass protection. They're bailing out of there, back to zone. But you see a lot of communication up front. They're trying to get one-on-one with those defensive ends. They want the tackles to have to block the defensive ends man-on-man.
Third and 12. Blitz coming. Smith looking for help. None there. And down he goes in the arms of Earl Everett, who lost his helmet chasing Troy Smith.
Helmet? I don't need no stinking helmet, says Earl Everett.
Earl says this game's too important.
This is all out. Brandon Seiler flushes him, coach, and then look at the backside pursuit.
Let's give Florida credit. Look at this effort. Is that something? You talk about how important this game is.
See how Moss spilled it? Even though he missed the tackle, he spilled it right to Earl Everett.
Look at the bench react to that. But let's give that Florida defense credit. They show zone. They blitz. They blitz one more guy than Ohio State can block.
Well, three and out for Ohio State. And now Trapasso angling toward the sideline. And a fair catch called for and made cleanly by James at the 9. 38-yard punt. Gators get it for the second time in the second half. Tonight's Tostitos National Championship game is brought to you by Budweiser Select. A gorgeous night in the Valley of the Sun. Glendale, Arizona, they're working on Earl Everett. He made the tackle a moment ago on Troy Smith without his helmet.
Make a tackle without a helmet, they got to give you a little extra attention, don't they?
First down for Florida. And they hand it off to Harbin, and he picks up two.
Guys, one of the stories I'm seeing in this ball game is the Florida offensive line. Coming into the game, we talked to a number of people, didn't we? We all talked to them independently, off the record, all that good stuff. And what did they tell us? That's a problem spot for Florida, a weak link. This is a group of guys who have played all year long together, came into the season with 17 combined starts coming into this year. They've come together, been average most of the year, but tonight they've been dynamite.
Harbin in motion, he takes a screen and slips his way through a pair of Buckeye defenders and brings it out to the 17-yard line. Laurinaitis on the tackle.
Coach, when you don't have a good offensive line, how do you help them out?
You get the ball out of your hands. Let the quarterback get it out. You come untouched, but the ball's out. It's released quickly.
And from a shotgun position and a couple more steps, you're 7-8 yards deep. That's a long way to go for the lineman to get to the quarterback.
Yeah, you've got your jitterbug out in space.
That's Phil Trotwine, Jim Tart, Steve Rissler, Drew Miller, and Carlton Metter up front for the Gators. Third down and two. Play fake to win. Safe throw. Catch by Latsko. They'll move the chains out to the 22.
Isn't he a great story? You touched on him earlier, Tom. Billy Latsko. Grandfather played at the University of Florida, played quarterback. His father played at the University of Florida. Billy Latsko was a walk-on, born to be a Gator. Mom's a graduate of Florida. Construction management major. Helped build some buildings in the offseason. What he did was he worked full-time and then went and worked out to get ready for the year.
Yep.
That's the kind of kid you want in your ball club.
You're seeing a lot of short passes. We talked about the lack of running game, but that short passing game supplements.
It is the running game.
It supplements the running game. It's the same thing. It's a high percentage pass, easy throw.
Option, and Luke pitches to win. Tries to cut it back the other way and is surrounded by the Buckeye defense. Well, you take a peek on that Ohio State sideline. What a shame.
Oh.
Ted Ginn Jr. now aided by crutches after the injury early in the game. For those of you that weren't with us, Ginn returned the opening kickoff of this national championship, 93 yards for a touchdown. He was injured on Ohio State's first offensive possession, has not returned, and it appears he will not return.
Big, big blow, not just to him, but to the offense overall for Ohio State.
Well, they look lost without it. Inside handoff to Caldwell, and Pitcock ran him down after being chased by Jay Richardson. But a Ted Ginn Jr. opening kickoff, 93 yards for a touchdown. First team All Big Ten, second team All American. Perhaps the most exciting player in all of college football. He came racing back on the field, giving the Buckeye Nation hope. A sprained foot, and he will stand and watch. with weight on crutches.
You feel for such a great young man, an outstanding player, doesn't get a chance to play in this venue in such a big game.
Third down and 12. Leak under pressure, and down he goes in the arms of Vernon Golston. So now the Gators will punt from their own five.
You've seen that the Ohio State defense has responded this half. Sure some coaches had some things to say at half, but I'll tell you, they responded. That's two times, three and out.
And what was so good about that was it was the coverage downfield that allowed Vernon Golston, number 50, and Jay Richardson, number 99, to finally get to Chris Leak. Nowhere to go with the football, allowed the pressure to get to him.
Wilbur puts a leg into this one, sending Gonzalez all the way back to his own 32. And he tiptoes along the sideline and steps out of bounds at the 43, and a late flag comes in. Not sure where this is coming from. Right along the sideline on the Florida side. Jack Folliard, our referee tonight, this Pac-10 officiating crew working the national championship game. Urban Meyer doesn't look very happy.
Your coach is worried about field position. Both of them, this is going to be a big one.
Member of the kicking team went out of bounds on his own, came back in. That's a foul against the kicking team, 5 yards previous spot. We're going to determine whether that foul will be accepted or not.
But fortunately, he didn't come back in and actually make a play.
I think they'll take the ball right there.
Read the lips of Urban Meyer. Yeah. He's telling him that's a bad call.
And what they're saying by the penalty. Yeah, it's a bad call in emphatic language.
Is declined.
He called it.
First
coach.
Down.
Well, Urban's trying to get the officials' attention. He's got a whole half yet.
We have 6:18 to play in the third quarter. It's been all Gator D so far tonight. Our Taco Bell impact players of the game. There's high impact Chris Leak and very low impact for anything offensively for Ohio State, Antonio Pittman, for 37 rushing yards. And the winner earlier of our Taco Bell Get the Tea promotion, Jill Martin from Atlanta, racing out there to get it. Well done, young lady.
Nice done. How about that? Touch the line, pick it up.
Troy Smith, Mr. Everything. Heisman Trophy winner, only 2 of 8, has been under heavy pressure, and that's Anthony Gonzalez for a 3-yard gain on first down.
The game now has to go back on Troy Smith's shoulders. Now that doesn't seem like much of a statement, it has been before, but they're down 34-14 in the third quarter. He will probably throw more than run the ball, but the offensive line has got to protect him. Even on that pass, plenty of pressure in his face. The Florida offensive, Florida defensive line whipping the Ohio State offensive line this game.
Gain on a play of 3, and the option, the pitch to Antonio Pittman. And he steps out of bounds, good enough for an Ohio State first down to the Florida 41. Let's check in once again downstairs with Chris Myers.
Tom, senior linebacker Earl Everett, who's being used somewhat as a spy on Troy Smith. He's the one who made the tackle without the helmet. He has a bloody nose and a cut. But as the trainer said, that's the reason we wear helmets. He is back in the game playing for the Gator defense.
So that's the reason.
How about this guy, what he's been through? Suffered from silent seizures as a kid and has overcome that to become the productive player he is today.
Empty backfield.
Smith looking around, and a penalty flag comes in right around the line of scrimmage. Will this be holding against Ohio State?
That was a dangerous throw. Threw off the back of his foot.
Guys, yep. I think a lot of people at home, we're going to hear the official word, and then I want to ask you, Coach Alvarez.
Holding on the offense, number 71. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
Coach, I think a lot of people at home are saying, how in the world Does this Ohio State offense look this bad tonight? Is all the credit the Florida defense, or are they just also having a bad night?
Well, the Florida defense, first of all, has made a lot of people look bad this year. They're only giving up 13 and a half points a game. I think that they're a little sluggish, but you have to give the Florida defense all the credit.
And they really are suffering, Ohio State, without Ted Ginn. Seems like they've lost a little spark without him in the game, too.
Smith fires to the far side, and the catch is made by Gonzalez. He'll be 2 yards shy of a first down. Second and two, clock rolling down to 5 minutes in the third quarter.
Watch how else you chip away at timing. Watch there, just redirect wide receiver, throw him out there a little bit. Makes it a tougher catch downfield. You try and get the little jam, take away the timing between quarterback and receiver. Haven't been able to call Anthony Gonzalez's name very much either. Take a look at the leading tacklers. Guys dividing up. The spoils of victory thus far for Florida.
Showing pressure again.
Second and 12. Broken up beautifully by Ryan Smith, who played for Urban Meyer at the University of Utah, and a new rule put in by the NCAA where if a player graduates in 3 years academically, they can transfer and not sit out a year.
That has now been rescinded
already.
1 year.
1 year and out.
Florida took advantage of it.
And remember, Urban Meyer was totally against that rule when it was passed, and his athletic director said, hold it a sec, Jeremy Foley said, you got a chance to get a pretty good player. You sure you're against it? For this year, he's all for it.
Well, Ohio State's getting in the neighborhood now where they have got to score on this drive.
Watch the push up inside.
Here they come after Smith. Throws nowhere close to Anthony Gonzalez. If you're Jim Tressel, fourth and 12, are you going here in the third quarter down 20?
I think they're going to play field position here, puck the ball away, and give their defense another chance. They've had two stops, and they want to give their offense the best opportunity. Fourth and 12 here with a confused group. I kick the ball away.
Florida has shown pressure and come on that series, not making Troy Smith make a decision quickly. That ball has to come out of his hands because he has somebody running clean right to him.
Under four and a half to play in the third quarter. Trapasso toward the far side. We'll see where they spot this. And they're saying the 20-yard line, 21-yard line. 4:19 to play in the third, and the Gators lead by 20. Our overhead shots of tonight's Tostitos National Championship game provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. DLP is the official HD TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing, it's the mirrors.
Guys, look at the D-line of Ohio State. They've got new guys in. Lawrence Wilson's in the game now. Thought I saw Todd Denlinger, number 92, trying to get some fresh legs. That's Alex Barrow, number 78.
Leak under center will hand it off to Deshaun Wynn, his biggest carry of the day, and pulls his way to the 31.
And that did not last long because coming on the field right now are the starters for Ohio State on defense.
Well, that's what happens when you give up a 17-yard run.
Watch the gash right here, coach, coming right at you. Look at 67 leading up in there. Jim, that's Drew Miller, number 67.
Well, they got a lot of movement on the defensive line. Charles, that you wanted to give, want to see how long they could last.
I might have been able to limp through there for 3 or 4 yards on that one.
17-yard run by Wynn, who had 16 rushing yards in the game. And now it's Tim Tebow. And he picks up 3 to the 35.
You know, I go back to something Urban Meyer said, that he likes to bother defenses. And what he means by bother them, he says the best way to do that is through by running option, running empty sets, and running unbalanced sets. We've seen all three of those tonight from Florida, and to say that they bothered Ohio State is putting it mildly. They've been dominating.
Somewhere along the line, Urban was a defensive coordinator.
And he's hung out with one.
That you hate to see.
But he does a lot of study with people, and he got the right words.
Marvin in motion, they're going to get him the football. dancing around, looking for some daylight. He's out maybe for a pickup of one. Third down upcoming. We're under 3 minutes in the third quarter. And the Florida Gators leading 34-14.
Now, we've seen that play from Florida a few times tonight because they like to, what they call, match up on offense. Get something to get the ball to a guy, a playmaker out in space who can dominate guys downfield. But we've seen that a number of times. I'm thinking the counter's coming before long. Fake quick screen, throw back to the other side.
They have not thrown the ball down the field today. Everything's been controlled passing game. Find the creases, dunk the ball.
Gators 8-13 on third down. This is third and six. Leap underneath, first down. Out to the 47-yard line. That's Jamel Cornelius.
They're getting the linebackers to vacate so much that you're finding the gap underneath. See the drops by the linebackers? They're out of there. Laurinaitis, number 33. Freeman, number one. Those are really deep drops, Coach, and that allows the guy underneath to catch the ball.
Larry Grant, number six, looked the wrong way. Needed to look to the strength of the formation and locate the underneath receiver. He's looking to the wrong side of the formation.
Big pump fake one way, long ball the other way, and well away from the intended receiver, Dallas Baker.
Something about the symmetry of these numbers that Florida has, 5, 6, 7, and 8, right? Look at the all-purpose yardage, a couple of touchdowns out of that group. I know right now, Dallas Baker saying, you know, I knew I should have worn number 9.
Right.
That maybe I would have gotten to as part of this discussion, and he's had a nice night himself.
You know, the last thing Urban said is, as we talked to him the other day, I want to put the ball in my playmaker's hands, and that's exactly what they've done to me.
Caldwell in motion, they'll give it to Wynn. And he picks up 2, maybe 3, another third down upcoming. The Gators are 9-14 on third down conversions in the game.
How about putting the ball in the hands of a true freshman with a national title on the line? Direct snap to him, throwing a little wide receiver screen, little swing pass to him. As you mentioned, Coach, put in the hands of playmakers. They want to make it easy for Percy Harvin to have the ball. Nothing real complicated. Look at the end result. He finds his way into the end zone.
Now he finds his way on the sideline. You're talking about a guy who this season, at 18 years young, averaged nearly 13 yards per touch. Play clock expired, it appeared, before Lee got the snap.
Timeout from the bench. The bench alertly called it.
Florida, number one.
I was taking a look at.
We'll get back to that in a minute. With this Gator effort so far tonight.
Three-man rush again.
On a third and seven. Catch made by Harvin, trying for the second effort to get the first down. He doesn't get it, and there's a penalty flag in the backfield.
Ran right by Larry Grant, number six, who actually backed out of the line to try and play that crossing route. Too quick for him and still got the ball in there.
They showed a four-man pressure and bailed him out. He was a spy looking for any underneath routes, but he just couldn't run with him. That's a defensive lineman.
Laurinaitis appears to be shaken up for Ohio State. Winner of the Bronco Nagurski Award.
Different type of game for the Ohio State defense tonight. They've had to play it retreating instead of attacking as they have most of the year.
Holding against the offense, number 75. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
One thing I noticed on this last possession, when Florida called the bench, a timeout from the bench, the huddle was broken with 15 seconds. They're trying to shorten the game. They didn't want the ball snapped until it's under 5 seconds. They're going to shorten this fourth quarter.
Trying to milk it. You got to be careful with that because you shut down your offense and you do it too much.
Gonzalez waiting for a fair catch. That ball batted back. And it will be downed at the 5. Nope. And the far side set across the goal line. And in college football, once it just breaks that plane,
See, tips
it's
it there.
It's a touchback.
That's right.
And because it had crossed the line, it, as you said, Tom, it broke the plane of the goal line. If it had been another league, a Sunday league, might have had a chance to have that play. Because he was in the end zone, but he hadn't touched when his feet hadn't touched when he tipped the ball.
Clock will start as Ohio State quickly gets to the line of scrimmage. Jim Tressel's Buckeyes down by 20 in the final seconds here of the third quarter. And they hand it to Antonio Pittman. No room to run to the 21. Wrapped up by Brandon Seiler.
Florida's defensive line getting a terrific push inside over the guards of Ohio State. Steve Rearing, number 71, having a particularly difficult time with the defensive front of Florida.
And that line cannot get up on the linebackers. They cannot combo and touch the linebackers, thus leaving those linebackers run free.
Running free and clean and making hits right now as the quarter winding down.
And that will be the final play of the third quarter. The Florida Gators celebrate their 100th anniversary of football this year. It took them 90 years to win their first national championship. They're one quarter away from getting number two. We continue on Fox after these messages from your local station. And the Gator defense has made Ohio State fall into a black hole through the first three quarters of this game. Smith underthrows his intended receiver, Anthony Gonzalez. That'll bring up third down and 9 for Ohio State as we're underway in the fourth quarter.
The coverage is just smothering right now. I mean, Troy Smith threw directly into coverage. To me, he was hoping something good would happen on that play. There was nothing there. Ryan Smith's coverage on Anthony Gonzalez, he was right on his shirt.
It looks like Troy Smith is very frustrated right now. He ran motion out of the backfield. The defensive back came all the way across the field. There's no way he could cover him. Having come that far, he didn't look at him.
The motion of a guy out of the backfield, it doesn't really hurt you.
Moss coming, and he got it. The Buckeyes are 1-for-8 on third down. Coach, you said first down would be critical. They're averaging second and 8-plus tonight.
They've answered the offensive line. The pass protection is confused. They're sliding the line away. He goes untouched.
Coach, I've always been told an unblocked player should make big plays. Jarvis Moss's eyes must have just lit up and said, are you kidding me?
That was a sprint.
You turned me loose like that?
That is the fourth time Troy Smith has been sacked tonight. James from midfield brings it down to the 39. Jarvis Moss, the last 2 years overcoming a mysterious illness that jeopardized his career. He's making Troy Smith and the Buckeyes ill tonight. The Florida Gators came in allowing only 13.5 points per game. And tonight have more than stood up against one of the most prolific offenses in all of college football, Ohio State. Bear in mind, one of the two Ohio State scores came on a kickoff return, the opening kick in this BCS National Championship game. And now leak to throw on first down and throws it away.
Boy, has he managed this game well? And how many times have we seen him make the proper decision? No one open, throw the ball away. Don't take the sack, live to fight another down.
And he hasn't gotten greedy.
No.
He hasn't tried to take the ball down the field. He's been schooled. There's going to be a deep zone, drop. You're going to have seams. Work the seams, be patient. That's exactly what he's done.
I can only think of one really questionable throw that he's made all night. He's had a terrific evening.
talking about a young man who's gone through a pair of head coaching changes during his 4 years at Florida. Three different offensive systems, if you will. Leak breaks it to the outside and steps out of bounds. First down, Gators. His father, Curtis, a former NFL camp receiver, put Chris and his brother, CJ, who was a quarterback at Tennessee, through pro-style workouts when Chris was 5 years old. When he originally committed to Florida, Steve Spurrier was still officially their head coach. Spurrier went on to the NFL. In came Ron Zook. Out he went. In came Urban Meyer. Many felt that Lee could not succeed in this style of offense. And here he is 13 minutes and 40 seconds away from silencing so many that have ridden him so hard for 4 years at Florida. And there are a lot of them up there who will jump on his bandwagon tonight.
False start on the offense, number five. Five-yard penalty, first down.
When you look at Leak's career, the Florida record holder.
Look at that.
Passing yards, 11,000. Most attempts, most completions. Only Danny Werfel threw and has thrown more touchdown passes at Florida than Chris Leak.
And most of the records he broke are Danny Werfel's, which is part of the reason it's hard for people to embrace Chris Leak, because Danny Wonderful won a national championship. This could change everyone's perception and thought processes about Chris Leak tonight if they manage to close this one out.
Dangerous throw there, and a catch is made along the sideline by Cornelius Ingram. That seemed to float for a long time.
Had no reaction from the secondary.
Not at all.
The ball was thrown across the field with nothing on it. You saw no defender react to it.
He was so open that he could get away with this one and allowed Cornelius Ingram to actually adjust and turn back inside to catch the ball. It was meant to be thrown to the outside. But as you mentioned, Coach, no one there to react. Thus, a completion.
It's interesting. Normally in this situation, you run the clock. You run by running the football. They're throwing the ball.
Not now with Tebow.
Not with Tebow.
And that's a first down and then some. Tebow down to the 7. He just ran right through Laurinaitis.
Earlier in the game, it was simply the ISO. This is almost a counter. Watch how Tim Tebow moves left and then comes back right. Latsko folds around number 42, leading and right up into the hole. Look at how they figured it out. Troutwine 75 up front. Latsko with the big block. Baker 81 trying to get something done downfield.
Tebow again is Florida's leading rusher in the game. He's still in there and he's going to carry it again. And he is met head on by Marcus Freeman at the 5. Well, we're under 12 and a half. And time, oh, beginning to wind down on the undefeated Ohio State Buckeyes.
You don't have many possessions left. Somehow that ball has to come out.
Yeah.
You've got to be trying to strip the ball, get the football out of there.
You can't get a moral victory and make them kick a field goal
No.
here and have it count. They've got, as you said, Coach, they've got to force a turnover.
I'm trying to strip it from Tebow is like trying to strip it from King Kong.
And look, both quarterbacks in. Tebow lined up at the tailback position. That's him right there.
And now Leak will run off.
And we can't put his hands under center.
Ball start. Move. Number 84 on the offense. 5 yard penalty. Second down.
You know, for many of you wondering about that have not watched the Gators play this season, the whole Chris Leak story, which we've documented, bear in mind when Tebow signed, as heavily recruited quarterback as there was in all of high school football across the country last
Yes.
year, you're talking about a young man who owns Florida high school records for total offense, career passing yards, and touchdowns, either throwing or running, 159 of them. Just about everyone in Gainesville wanted Tebow as the man from day one.
They'll get plenty of them next year.
Harvin down to the 2. And just to finish that thought, all of us in unison on agreement with this. The Florida Gators are not playing in the championship game tonight. Taking nothing away from Tebow, but if he's their every down quarterback rather than Leak, they're not here tonight.
That's exactly right. And I'm telling you, it takes a special coach to communicate, and you need a person like Leak to accept that. But it was an explanation both of you are going to play.
Gators going to spend a timeout, 11 minutes to play in Arizona. And a lot.
That was the dream then. With us holding up the one in confetti, with the confetti coming down. The image that plays through my head time and time again is seeing the Texas quarterback last year hold that number one up. That's been a dream of mine ever since I've seen him do it. And that'll be the perfect ending.
Brandon Siler's Florida Gators are 11 minutes away from that kind of celebration. Leading Ohio State 34-14, third down and goal for the Gators. Stacked eye formation, it's Wynn. And he will be denied a touchdown. We'll see if they send out Hetland for a field goal or they're going to go for it on fourth and goal at the one.
You put the game away, you can put the game away, and if you don't make it, they've got to go 99 yards.
I think it's an excellent decision by Urban Meyer, and they brought the hammer back in at quarterback Tim Tebow. His favorite play has been the isolation.
Tebow straight ahead into the end zone, and the Gators have put this one on ice.
Penalty.
Things getting a little chippy in there, guys. The frustration coming out, I'm sure.
Not sure there was a flag, maybe an inadvertent flag.
There's a lot of talk after the play, though. We'll have to keep an eye on that.
Well, now Florida's a man short. Sprinting out there is a big fella, Ronnie Wilson.
He was in on the last play, got so excited by the touchdown, he ran off the field. And I forgot he had to be in on the extra point.
And when Ronnie Wilson runs on the field, as that one is deflected, but it's still good, and that's the kind of game it's been for the Gators.
It's a big night for the Gators.
Tebow to the end zone. 41-14, Florida. On game shift of the night. The Florida defense shifting into high gear in pursuit of the Heisman Trophy winner, Troy Smith. He has been chased and frequently tracked down all night by this sensational Florida defense. 84 yards of total offense for the Buckeyes, who average over 400 yards of offense per game.
Wasn't it Jarvis Moss who said that Florida's defense planned to shock and awe Ohio State's offense with their speed, and we wondered if they could really do that? I think we have an answer now.
Maurice Wells, who's a Florida native from Jacksonville, brings it out. And the Gators, with 10-10 to go, are ready to celebrate in grand fashion tonight. To Ike Killiard, got it rolling, and it never stopped for Steve Spurrier's Gators. 52 points, nearly 500 yards of offense, domination in a 52-20 final.
And that was a rematch game. Florida State had beaten them in the regular season, and everything broke well. Ohio State actually beat Arizona State in the Rose Bowl that year, which opened the way for Florida to win a national title.
Play blown dead before it ever got started.
False start on the offense, number 72. 5-yard penalty, first down.
If somebody would have told you the numbers would look like this for Ohio State tonight, you would have looked at whoever said that to you and said you need to check in and get a straight jacket ASAP.
This is an offense that hasn't been slowed down all year. What a job by this defense.
Troy Smith has hit on just 4 of 13, 35 yards, been sacked four times. And that one falls incomplete.
You know who's as happy as anyone right now watching this ball game? Probably not here because he's in season. Billy Donovan, head basketball coach of Florida. If Florida closes this one out, they will be the first time in NCAA history you'll have the reigning NCAA basketball champions and football champions at the same time.
It's Billy pretty
Donovan,
good year.
Pretty good year. And Billy Donovan and Urban Meyer were neighbors back home in Florida. They worked together quite well, closely, and Urban Meyer was at the NCAA championship game last year in the locker room after the game, absorbed the feeling and wanted to experience it himself, and he just made tonight.
Smith pressured, escapes it for the time being, and down he goes. Fifth time he's been sacked tonight. It was Harvey who will get credit for the sack, his third in the game. He made the contact, threw him, and Smith fell down.
They've been relentless. They haven't slowed down all night. No. He really has had nowhere to go with the ball.
That's the perfect word for it, Coach, relentless, because they didn't just run right to him on that play. They had to go around a few guys, traverse through a little bit of traffic, and still made the play. The secondary, once again, covering the receivers downfield. Nowhere for the Heisman Trophy winner to go with the football.
Frustration indeed for Troy Smith. Notice handed off to Antonio Pittman. And he's out to the 15-yard line. And Ohio State will walk off the field offensively. Even though this has been such a disappointing night for Smith, you can't overlook his career and just the journey for Smith to get to this game. Grew up in the tough streets of Cleveland, separated from his mother, Tracy, for 4 years while she battled her own personal demons. He met three men who he calls his personal angels. The first two, a midget football coach named Erwin White, his high school football coach, Ted Ginn Sr., who restored his self-esteem, and then Jim Tressel, who taught him how to become a man. And that he has been for Ohio State, the man. But tonight, it's a night to celebrate Florida. Well, they are hooting and hollering if you're wearing blue and orange tonight, and in large part because Evan Smith was leading the Gator chop.
I have a question, guys. Are the Gators just going to win everything this year? Football, basketball, Dancing with the Stars? I mean, they're leaving no titles out there for anyone, are they?
Oh, boy.
And for Troy Smith, you know, you almost wonder, obviously, as you said, Tom, you can't wipe out the career. If this stays the way it will, say it stays the way it is right now, this will only be the second loss he's ever suffered against a top 10 team. He came into the game 10-1 as a starter against top 10 opposition with his best ball games against those teams.
Boy, and he's such a likable kid.
The story is unbelievable because he could have gone south so easily. And the influence of the men you named and the other people in his life.
And he's back reunited with his mother again. Yes. After a tough 4 years away from one another. She's doing well. They're very, very close.
He actually has given her the Heisman Trophy.
Yep.
Said she deserves it for what she's been through and how she's battled back. It's a terrific story. Just tonight, the story is not enough.
You know, and you talk to anyone on that Ohio State football team about leadership, and Troy Smith is the guy that they bring up. They follow his lead.
You know, his offensive coordinator, Jim Bowman, his quarterback coach, Joe Daniels, both had some medical issues in the last year. They both have credited Troy Smith with helping them recover, because he'd show up every day with film and say, I know you can't do much, coach. Well, can we just watch this film? It's paid off with 12 wins this year.
Third down and four. They're going to milk the clock, play clock. They hand it off to Wynn, and they'll milk it some more. Wynn to the 38. That'll bring us down to 6 minutes and then some. Let's check in with Chris Myers.
Tom, the players on the Gator bench saying, I can feel it, I can taste it. You showed Danny Werfel and that championship team. His words, he spoke as a senior, are on the back of this card. On the other side, the championship ring of that year. Urban Meyer gave this card out to all of the Florida Gators earlier this year when they suffered their only loss of the year against Auburn, emphasizing the point at that time that despite one loss, just like that year with Werfel when they lost to Florida State, you can win a championship. championship if you stay together and play hard. And that's what the Gators are about to do. And as some of them said today, they carry these cards in their pocket. They'll have new cards to hand out to future Gators.
And win, as we mentioned earlier, the kid who walked away from the very heart of Ohio State football land growing up in Cincinnati will be able to go back to the Queen City after this school year is over and lay it on the Buckeye fans.
And there's the unity chain as worn by Brandon Seiler. He created that. All the guys on defense have their names on dog tags on that unity chain. He unveiled it before the LSU game when they ran on the field this year and said, everybody, come together. Everyone be a part of the link of a great Florida defense. And now they're going to have a piece of championship link to add on to it.
No gain down to the 25-yard line for Keaston Moore, his first carry tonight. Our aerial coverage of tonight's Tostitos National Championship game on Fox is brought to you by Budweiser Select.
Well, this Ohio State defense has been on the field all night. Florida has had 36 minutes time of possession.
And have run how many extra plays than Ohio State? And when you take a look at that, that has to translate into easily more than 2-1 in terms of offensive plays run.
Florida just letting that play clock run all the way down just before it hits zero, before the snap of the football. They'll hand it to Moore, and he's inside the 20 to the 19. And we are under 4.5 minutes to play in Glendale, Arizona. The Buckeyes, the most points they've allowed in a game since November of 99 against Illinois.
Amazing.
All the credit in the world goes to this Florida Gator coaching staff and the players executing on the field.
You have two coaches who are big game coaches. Urban Meyer, 8-3 against ranked teams. Jim Tressel's record against in bowl games against the Michigans of the world has been spectacular. Urban Meyer had this team ready to play.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Vin lost his footing.
Since we're throwing out all the stats, Vin Scully here, right? Throughout the stats, Urban Meyer at all of his stops with more than a week to prepare. Coming into tonight, 20-2. Now we'll be 21-2. So when you talk about preparing a team, having a layoff, he understands it. How did he get this team ready? He divided it into three phases. And what he did was he ramped up to what he called game day. And then they take a day off since they didn't have a game to play. Come back, do it again. And then tonight was the third week of game day. And they actually played and played quite well, obviously. At what point does he bring Malik off to an ovation? I'm wondering if he's thinking that. Let that kid go out and let the Florida faithful really cheer for him.
They're going to throw it to Harbin, and he's very close to another Gator first down as the clock winds to 3 minutes exactly. And depending on the spot of the ball.
If it's a first down here, I'd like to run Tim Tebow out and give Chris Leak a chance to come out and get an ovation.
We talked so much about Urban Meyer, but I know I'm speaking for the both of you guys. After being around Jim Tressel and this program he has at Ohio State, this will be in his 6 years, the fourth time they finished in the top five. 62-13 is record, including a national championship. That's a first down. The Buckeyes will play in more national championship games under Jim Tressel. But this night belongs to a young man born and raised in the Buckeye State, Urban Meyer from Ashtabula, about a 3-hour ride outside of Columbus.
And Tom, I don't think it's the only time we're going to see that guy competing for national championships either.
13 true freshmen contributing.
First down, going to hand it to Wynn. And he's to the 14-yard line. We're under 2:30. And our All-State good hands play of the game. This is all you need to know. How good was the Florida defense? They leave their helmets on the field. and still caught Troy Smith tonight.
Hey, football, rugby, whatever.
That showed the attitude of that football team.
National title on the line. Let's go make plays. What an impressive, impressive night. No other way to put it. Every phase for Florida.
Deshaun Wynn close to the 10-yard line. You know, we were talking about Troy Smith and his relationship with his mother. And how about for Reggie Nelson? Our DLP Ultimate Picture Cam tonight bringing you great shots. DLP is the official HD TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing. It's the mirrors. You don't know whether or not Reggie Nelson will go on to play in the NFL next season. But Charles, his mother died 4 days before Christmas.
Yes, the woman they called Miss Mary, Mary Lakes, former school custodian, had breast cancer for 3 years. She passed away December 21.
Yep.
Reggie fortunately was able to get home.
What a feeling.
As cold as that is, it feels so good.
It feels so good. And he doesn't mind flash dancing out of there, does he?
Going to be a tough goodbye for Jim Tressel. With Troy Smith leaving after tonight, already having earned his degree in communications. And this is going to do it. For the second time in 100 years of football at the University of Florida, the Gators celebrate as national champions. What a night indeed for Chris Lee. His final game at the University of Florida. And he leaves a champion. Let's go downstairs to Chris Myers.
Tom, I'm sorry, I'm spinning up confetti at the Florida bench with Dallas Baker, the senior who had the first touchdown of the game. Congratulations. A lot of people are surprised. Are you or the Gators?
Oh, no, I'm not surprised at all. I mean, nobody never gave us a chance, but we came here with a chip on our shoulder, and we had something to prove, really. I mean, they said it was going to be 42-14 Ohio State. It ended up being 41-14 the University of Florida. It's been like this all year. Nobody gave us a chance, and finally we could throw up a number one.
And there was some doubt whether you deserved to even be here in this game, right?
Yeah, well, like I said, we had a lot of doubters out there, the media, Ohio State fans. I mean, nobody really gave us a chance. But nobody could doubt us now because, hey, we're national champs.
All right, you're not going to propose or anything, right? No, okay, then I'm just kidding. It's an inside joke.
Hey, I'm not going to propose, but I just want to say I love everybody back home in New Smyrna, the prep school up in Massachusetts, Volusia County, Daytona,
right,
I mean.
And all of Florida, they're number one, Tom.
Gainesville especially, baby. We're breaking it home.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. We invite you to stay tuned after the game for the DirecTV post-game show. We'll have the trophy presentation and our DirecTV Look Again replay.